Bonjour à tous. Et bienvenue pour le cirque. Non, je plaisante. C'est juste un événement circus, machin. Ça ressemble à ça. Les terrains sont décorés. Et il y a un chapiteau. Ça se termine dans environ 6 heures. Pardon. Donc, bah on est parti. On va continuer tout de suite. On va affronter les wizards. Ouais. Et puis, bah, on continue notre route direction les playoffs. En espérant gagner suffisamment de matchs pour être sélectionné. Ah, on est chez nous. On est à la maison. Oh le green. Ça va. On est parti.
Chimura and Bryant are in the middle. Shabazz Napier out there with Bradley Beal. And it's Brown in at the three slot. And for the Celtics, Hayward at small forward with Tatum at the four. Jaylen Brown out there with Jay. And it's Cantor in at the five spot. Four on the clock. Beal can't get it to go. Both teams dealing with injuries in this one tonight, Chris. Talk about what that does to a team's rotation.
Well, it shortens the rotation, definitely, but I always believe that injuries help teams in the long run if you get the injured player back. So as long as you get that injured player back before the playoffs and time to build chemistry, what does it do? It gives guys an opportunity that weren't going to get that playing time to get that playing time. And now it helps deepen that rotation the longer the season goes along. So it can also turn into a blessing. That curse can, but you got to have everyone focused and honed in to make sure that happens.
For sure. Jay dishes to Tatum. Brown kicks it over to Nash. No good from outside. And so it's Beal. He'll bring it up for Washington. Napier. Lead pass was put in.
Ma faute, première erreur. Mais c'est pas grave. Par contre, il y a un truc qui me saoule. C'est les pourcentages.
On its way from Hayward for two. Good, and the assist goes to Chase.
Well, they tailored their offense around him, and let me tell you, he loves playing in this system.
Nice ball movement by Washington. Here's Beal.
Les pourcentages qui sont apparus avec le dernier bonus que j'ai mis d'attaque. Ouais, ça permet de voir au niveau des shoots. Je crois que c'est le pourcentage de réussite au niveau du shoot. Alors ça va peut-être ça va peut-être m'aider.
New York. There's Brown with the three. Good on the triple.
Well, that's a look they always want him to take, because if he's got the space, he's got the green light.
The Celtics have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far today. Now about 3 minutes gone in the first quarter. There's Nash with the three. Trains the three-pointer.
Kevin, I love the answer back there by Che. He is a competitor at the highest level.
Ouais, j'ai vu un pourcentage vert, je me suis dit quand c'est vert, c'est bon.
It's a three-point game. They are coming into this having notched a win against the Knicks in their last game.
Well, it helps when your opponent makes that many mistakes. I thought that was the story of the game.
J'ai cru qu'il allait partir sur le côté et revenir. J'ai fait une passe aller où, mais non.
Wizards trail by three. Quarter of action, just under 3.5 minutes played. Here's Hachimura, guarded by Tatum. Hachimura, no good.
And the activity he shows around the rim is why he is such a respected defender. Yeah, you can see why he's established that reputation. Strong understanding of how to defend at the rim.
Il y a le fil de mon micro qui me gêne. Ça de mon casque.
Wizards making a switch here. Waiters has checked in. Now here's Waiters. Looking at his point production, he averages almost 11 points a game.
He gets the playground jumper and can't make good on it. So you don't get many chances.
Ah merde, j'ai cru que c'était un joueur sur le côté, mais c'était l'arbitre.
And Cal Berkeley not the biggest basketball program in the country, so Chris, what led Brown to go there?
Well, former NBA All-Star Shareef Abdul-Rahim, another Wheeler High alum, took the same path. Look, Kevin, both of them welcomed the intellectual challenge. Now, Shareef, not only could he hoop, but now he's the president of the G League. And Jaylen Brown, he's the vice president of the Players League.
They've wasted no time settling into their offense.
To end the run. Good, nice play there from Napier.
He's got some pep in his stuff tonight.
Ouais, j'ai mal
very solid first quarter for him at the offensive end.
Now here's Nash. He had 27 points last game. Cantor against Bryant. Cantor, the pass to Chain. Good work defensively by Bryant.
And he thought he had a clear path to the hoop, but the defense didn't give up on that play and cut him off.
Boston leading by 7. Brown the pass to Nash. And it's sent back by Bryant. Brown wide open. He fired.
Ça c'est pas possible, je me suis fait bâcher. J'ai envie de dire comme d'habitude, mais
bon.
Oh non, il fait une faute. Pourquoi, je ne sais pas, mais...
So it's the Wizards now. They trail by 9 points. Pound kicks to Napier. Got a piece of it.
Great D there. Just quick hands on that one.
Nash drives in.
And oh non.
Extend the lead to double digits.
He's not using his head this quarter.
J'arrive à récupérer le ballon, je fais n'importe quoi.
And here's Brown outside.
Just doing the job on the backboard.
Brown with it, and it's Waiters picking him up. Brown, good.
Defensively, they've got to pick up the intensity. Hard to win, surrendering this high a field goal percentage.
Waiters outside. Brown feeling it out a bit. Just five on the clock. Fires for three. Boston with the rebound. This game coming after a loss against the Bucks.
Yeah, I mean, on the road, their defense was just overrun. Couldn't match the intensity of the opponent, and it cost them.
They looked overmatched. Yeah, I thought they lacked aggressiveness and hard out.
And count it. The shot is good. He'll go to the free throw line.
Joli.
Such a...
Avec la faute.
A little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second quarter. Nash against Beal. Shea outside. And he's good on the three ball. Shea's got his second bucket tonight.
Offensively, defensively,
oui.
They are in total
j'ai tenté.
Control.
Starting to take over here, building a big lead that could ultimately prove insurmountable.
Brown and Hayward, they're the wing. Tatum and Cantor together down low.
Flashed
and it's Nash in at the point guard position. That's the Boston Five. The Wizards shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
Yeah, pretty good numbers on the season when you look at their free throw attempts, right around 70.
Par contre, je vais l'enlever ça parce que ça me perturbe.
Catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. Shea, in the last game against the Bulls, made some excellent decisions and plays. He added 27 points and drained a few from downtown. That was just the latest in a string of very productive games for him. We'll see if he can keep this streak going, Kevin.
Excellent, David. Yeah, he was very assertive in that last game, making things happen.
Absolutely made his presence felt. And I wouldn't be surprised if he tries to get it going early here tonight.
Bottom line, though, he's a pro. He understands his strength, and he knows how to play to them.
Here is Hayward, following the basket by Markieff Morris. The shot's good from Gordon Hayward.
And it's not easy trying to guard Hayward. Amazing at getting space off the pick.
Round the pass to Bryant. The wing, Morris. Six on the shot clock. Brown against Hayward. Brown, good. Brown's got six.
But the D didn't do a good enough job on him. He could be an ace when he gets a good look at three.
Pass to Canner. Three-point line, it's Nash, and again it's Boston converting.
Able to put up points from anywhere on the floor. Chase showing a nice stroke right there.
Brown finds Beal. Goes up from the top of the key, and no good. And the Celtics going the other way now.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to
push
this lead.
Oh, he did everything right there except hit the shot.
Here's Brown. And he overshot that one, missing. And here's Hayward. He'll bring it up for Boston. Oh, that was an impressive throwdown.
That's amazing, the creativity. And you see how fluid an athlete Tatum is.
Time called here.
Ah là, ça joue bien, là.
Over the last 40 years, a steady decline in
ah oui, j'avais pas regardé le score. Oui, effectivement, ça joue bien.
with transition defense, right?
Definitely. And let's give respect to the offensive rebounding that it should have. Whenever you had guys like Rodman, Popeye Jones, guys that used to just you'd have nightmares about because they were such great rebounders, Ben Wallace. Well, now it's a little bit different because those guys were playing the four position, right? So now at the four position, you have to get back on defense because if you're not, guys are shooting threes from Curry land in the four position because the game has evolved. And so now it is better to get back in transition than trying to get an extra possession for your team. You still want to attack the glass. You just want to make sure you know who's in the game at that time because now you have guys leaking out, getting a quick shot on that other end.
Hayward can't hit. Washington's gone 1-4 from three-point range in the second. Not a whole lot dropping out there for them. Here's Hachimura, defended by Hayward. Nash against Beal. The shot's good. Brown making the play. That's now 8 points for Beal.
Mm-hmm. Love the touch on that floater right there. Beal has the shot down to a science.
Nash against Brown. Jay, right side. Good work defensively by Bryant.
He's got to be disappointed with his performance, but it'll be easier to swallow if they keep the lead.
Brown against Brown. Outside, Beal. This one for three. Gordon Hayward comes up with the rebound.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
Oh, he's not going to miss that shot twice in a row. Trust me.
Ouais, non. Qu'est-ce qui se passe, mais...
It's Brown on the wing. To the paint, here's Bryant. And they call the foul, so he's got the and one chance here to make it a three-point play.
Yeah, outstanding job there of taking the harm and still able to finish.
Boston making a switch here. Green's checked in. A change for the Wizards. Mahimi's checked in. Now here's Che. 8 points for him. He feeds it to Cantor. And Cantor throws it down.
There's some things you just can't teach. That's Che with tremendous awareness for where everyone is around him.
Pound kicks to Mahimi. To Beal. Three-pointer. Drills it from outside. Beal's got 11 points.
Oh, the timing couldn't have been better on that assist.
Nash against Brown. Shea inside. With an average of around 19.5 points a game, his scoring has been a constant for them. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
Je sais pas, j'ai l'impression que depuis que j'ai les chiffres sous les joueurs, je suis perturbé. Joue plus comme avant. Joue plus sur le côté chiffres et tout ça, machin. Ah merde!
They get it back. Here's Mahimi. Oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. Nash, the pass to Hayward. There it is. It's Nash picking up the assists. Shea's got 4 assists in the game. The pass to Hachimura.
Je sais pas, après, c'est peut-être dans ma tête. Hein.
Bryant trying to free himself up. Hachimura, no good. Boston's gone 4-6 from outside the arc tonight. Jay passes to Poirier, and there it is for him. 6 points for him.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with their work down low.
Passes to Hachimura. The Wizards need to get a shot off here. The Wizards with another miss. Boston's gone 2-3 when they've stepped beyond the arc in the second quarter. Scooped up. Man. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Oh, that's just fearless in his approach. I love seeing Che attack the heart of that defense.
This is his first free throw of the game.
And 74%, you know, so-so. He probably wouldn't mind seeing it a little bit higher.
Looking at who's out there now for the Celtics. Robert Williams comes in for Gordon Hayward. And Smart subbed in for Jaylen Brown. Bertinus, he's checked in for the Wizards. Shabazz Napier comes in for Hachimura. Here's Che, following the bucket by the Wizards. Down low. And he lays it straight in. Nash has got 8 points in the quarter.
Ah, il faut que je mette un peu de panier de temps en temps, là, sinon ça va pas
aller.
And here's Napier. He had 22 points in the win against New York.
I mean, and you look at his free throw numbers. I mean, this shows you how much pressure he put on the defense. And getting going here in the second quarter, his second three-pointer of the game.
And here's Nash after the three-pointer from Bradley Beal. Here's Williams, first shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
You know, still a raw talent, but Williams does have a reliable inside game that continues to get better.
Napier kicks to Bertans. Good, and it's Napier with the assist that time.
Qui enchaîne les 3 points, dis donc.
Jay inside. Napier covering. Jay, no good. Napier with it. Jay's there. Up again. It's good on the putback.
And those second chance points really become almost like bonus points when you can get them.
Pass to Williams. Back to Jay. Shoots. That one, no good. Now the Wizards take it the other way. Last time they met was in Washington.
Well, if they want to avoid the outcome of that first meeting, they'll need to be stronger on the glass. They were completely outmatched in the last one.
They needed more fire and intensity tonight. Even if they don't win the battle of the boards, they have to put up a fight. If he was shooting even a little bit better, the story of this game would be a lot different.
Oui, je sais, c'est pas bien ce que j'ai fait.
Brown against Nash. Hand stolen by Jay. Here's Green.
C'est pas bien ce que j'ai fait, je lui ai demandé le ballon alors qu'il avait toute l'occasion de marquer quoi.
Yeah, they're pouring it on right here, trying to give the opposition no light at the end of the tunnel.
And so it's the Boston Celtics in very good shape with a 23-point lead at the end of the
mi-temps.
Thank you, David, and we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter.
Je suis loin de mes scores, quoi. Je dois marquer encore. Je crois que je dois faire 20-10, un truc comme ça.
It's been a clinic out there by Jaylen Brown.
Man, he's been running wild on him through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
And as they can't slow him down, you know what you do? Keep feeding them and feeding them and feeding them. This is the right game plan.
So the Wizards five right now. Hachimura and Bryant are in the middle. Shabazz Napier out there with Bradley Beal. And it's Brown in at the three. Beal's shot is good.
Look at the precision from Beal. It's just incredible. He loves slashing his way through the D with his ball handle.
Celtics leading by 23. And at times, Chris, reporters have talked about a rift between Beal and Wall. But you know what? Beal has nothing but great things to say.
Putain, on est au troisième quart-temps. Ils me font déjà un... Une défense à deux joueurs.
I mean, but Bill would much prefer to have Wall by his side.
Brown kicks to Bryant. The shot's good. Brown making the play. Brown's got three assists tonight.
Quand les mecs, faut les garder. S'ils font des 3 points comme ça, si souvent.
We see this all too often. You have to be willing to put it.
Baseline Jay, offensive rebound, Cantor, and that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. He's getting his first free throw attempt of the night right now.
And of course, we'd all like to see his percentage at the line improve, but he just. just does not have the touch right now. He's in the 60s.
Good shot selection, largely dependent on getting open. Which players do the best job of moving, you think, right now without the ball?
Period. Klay Thompson, 60 points, 11 dribbles. Did you hear me? 60 points,
shocking.
11 dribbles.
It almost looks like a mystery, doesn't it?
Yeah, it is.
And a look now at the Celtics' upcoming schedule. On Sunday, they'll begin a road trip.
Du gros match, les Bulls. Enfin, les Bulls, c'était pas du gros match la dernière fois, mais il y a les Raptors qui sont de retour. Raptors, c'est du gros quand même. Hein. C'est du gros. La dernière fois, c'était difficile.
And of course, the Celtics traded back from number one to number three to draft Tatum in terms of readiness and absolute steel.
Bryant dishes to Brown. And that one, good. Brown's got 10 points.
Nice and steady so far in the second half. They're 3-for-4.
And they double up Jay inside. And Hayward gets it to go on the assist by Nash. 10 points for Gordon Hayward.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking at the rim.
Beal gets a wide open look. A three-pointer is right on target.
They made the most of their.
Il est bon, je sais même pas s'il y en a loupé un de.
Nash outside to the inside. Canter.
Putain, comment il me tient le mec. Faut pas que je bouge, hein. Oh non, je fais une faute. Du calme.
Here's Hachimura. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Napier passes to Bryant. Here's Hachimura. Shot clock at 6. Napier feeling it out a bit. And again, Washington with the triple.
Yeah, these defenders had better start closing down on shooter.
Austin leading by 22. Jay outside. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
Ah, de temps en temps, faut que je marque aussi.
They've been unable to shut down the middle.
Now here's Napier, defended by Nash. Knocked loose and
joli.
Stolen by Hayward. And here we go. Brown wide open, he fired. The basket good off the assist.
Joli.
18 points for Jaylen Brown.
Well, how about the quickness of that release? Brown just training that catch and shoot jumper with ease.
Pass to Hachimura. And stolen by Jay. And he banks in the layup. Jay's got 4 points this
week. Hey,
well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Napier passes to Hachimura. To stop the run. Whistle blows. Basket is good. So a chance here for a. .158 left in the third quarter. Now Mahimi. 13 feet away. Rebounded by the Celtics. Tatum's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Here's Nash. That shot is in, just like 6 others have been for him. He's shooting 7 for 15.
Oh, nice look there from Smart. Finding the open man.
Wizards trail by 15. And Smart over to help. Waiters outside. And he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down.
Sauter trop tôt.
You know, the rest of the D can be stretched a little thin when the double team's in place like that.
Nash drives in, and yes, it's good. Shaves got 19 points.
Yeah, that was the third straight high percentage look the defense has allowed. The defenders have got to start putting bodies on bodies.
Mahimi kicks to Waiters. Thank you. Tatum. Again, the Wizards score.
And now they're shooting it pretty well. That was not something we would have said in that first half.
Now here's Jay. Defense is right there. And it's Williams throwing it down.
An unreal athlete. Williams gets off the floor with such ease to power it down.
Napier finds Waiters. 29 seconds left in the third. And Tatum pulls it down. Tatum's got 8 rebounds in this game. To the middle. And it's Hayward. That time on the assist by Nash. And that's 12 points for Gordon Hayward.
And that's 10 straight points in the paint. The defense, nowhere to be found.
Waiters against Nash. And it's Waiters again missing.
That's one he knows he should have drained.
Ah, dommage.
You can't look at the result.
Je voulais le mettre.
They'll take that whenever they get it.
You're exactly right. I mean, that's the kind.
Jay, he's feeling it tonight. And he's been the driving force for the Boston Celtics.
J'aurais voulu le mettre.
Standout at the offensive end, both with his scoring and his passing. We'll return shortly. And how about a look now at our assist of the game? Brought to you by State Farm.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Well, it's also called making a good read, understanding where everyone is and taking full advantage. Fantastic.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. Hayward and Williams together inside. Smart and Brown outside on the wings, and it's Jay in at the one. That's the Boston five.
Ah bah oui, non mais oui. Je crois qu'on n'a pas le droit de rester. Je suis plus sûr des règles, mais je crois qu'on n'a pas le droit de rester longtemps dans la surface. C'est pour ça qu'il n'y a jamais personne. Tant qu'on ne fait pas la passe en fait.
Plays it up and banks it in. Nash has got 21 in the game.
Moving it around, 8 of their last 10 coming off assists.
The Wizards shooting from the field, 44%, not bad. And stolen by Jay. Inside, poked loose, shoots over Brown, and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
But we all know Jay's a tricky cover. He could beat you and draw contact in so many different ways.
The shoe culture becoming a bigger part of the game. Signature shoe.
Ouais, ça se passe bien. Ça se passe bien.
PJ Tucker with over 4,000 pairs of shoes.
Ah, il est passé.
Are you a collector?
I love it, and it's all because of the Jordan phenomenon. What Michael Jordan did for the game, not just with the shoe, but what he did for the game and making it be so cool in the culture. I got to give my boys in Michigan, give us a little credit too with what we did there. But the shoe game has definitely
ça se passe très bien.
It's just crazy out of control. I love it, but no, yeah, I'm a little bit of collector.
Hayward passes to Chain. The basket good off the assist from Hayward. Hayward's got his fourth assist in this one.
He's really turned it around here in the second half. I mean, his offense has returned.
Washington calls timeout. And with a younger generation of fans cutting the cord, Adam Silver has talked about ways, Chris, to make the games, the NBA games, more accessible.
Yeah, and as a guy, Kevin, that played on the West Coast, I know many people aren't happy with this idea, but I say move the games up an hour. Move it to 6 o'clock so that I could watch LeBron on the West Coast when I'm living on the East Coast and be to bed by a normal time where kids can stay up. But how about the streaming? I mean, you can watch it on your phone. So many better and different ways now. I mean, before, if you were traveling, you could never watch a game because you had to be by a TV set stuck into a wall. Now, that's your phone, your pads, and everything else. So I love the game. It's becoming more global because of the expansion and how we've gotten players out there in front of fans. And now, with the access that fans have through some type of mobile device, I just love it. I love it.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
Back to Smart. Six to shoot. There's the pass to Poirier. There's Green with the three. Schofield grabs the board.
J'ai un peu fait n'importe quoi là. Je crois que j'avais des moyens de.
Here's Pasechnik to end the drought. Rebounded by the Celtics. Poirier's got his seventh rebound here tonight. And there's Nash. That's good on the assist from Smart. Smart's got three assists now in this one. Here's Schofield. Pass to Mahimi. Hey, Chris, for some guys, playing in their hometown is a dream. But there's also that added pressure, isn't there?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, at least when you play away from home, it's a little more quiet. You don't have to get as many tickets for the game. When I got a chance to play home in Detroit, it was one of the best moments of my life. And I thought to myself, this is a wonderful feeling, but could I have handled it for 15 years of my career? I don't know. That's 30 tickets a game. I probably would have to go back into the NBA again just to pay for those tickets.
Ça, ils arrêtent pas de me bâcher, ouais. Faire des passes. Ah, dommage.
Mahimi's got six rebounds now in the game. Now here's Napier. Covered by Jay.
And the foul. Oh non, il fait une faute.
That will get him his fourth foul of the game.
Dang, that's his fourth foul. Now he's gonna have to be careful. Still a little ways to go with only two fouls to spare.
Williams, he's checked in for the Celtics. Murray comes in for Smart. And a switcher also for Washington. Morris is checked in for Ian Mahimi. Nash, the pass to Poirier.
And there's merde! Putain, j'aurais dû bouger. Je fais n'importe quoi. Je pouvais shooter, j'ai appuyé sur passe.
Now, here's Napier. Not a lot of room. Now the dish to Bryant. Some nice D.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Ball's knocked loose. Nash outside. Down to five on the shot clock. Shoots the three. It's good.
Oh lolo. Nash has got a fatigué tout ça. Non, mais... Attendez. Ah, c'est bon. Non. J'avais eu un souci sur le retour. Merde. Sur le retour de Twitch, je veux dire. Oui, donc sur mon retour, mon retour Twitch.
Fashion and Chris music. Do you think it's always been this interwoven?
Oh, Kevin, please. You see the outfits they're wearing now? I gotta be like, the I old do. Funny buddy, the old guy. Oh, my goodness. Guys are basically coming into the game like, did you turn on the lights before you got dressed in your closet? Yeah. I mean, I know it's fashion. I'm not speaking about any one guy, but wow. I'm telling you, they're taking fashion to another level. And even though I joke about it, it's always fun anticipating what type of outfit. Want to see guys walking, especially I mean, come on, I love their games, and then I look and I say, wow, they have to be confident on the court because they wore that to the game, and they're confident in life all around,
overall, right? To the paint, here's Tatum, no good on that one. Now the Wizards take it the other way. The Oklahoma City Thunder will be in town for the next one. That game is the first and last of their homestand. Brown outside. And again, Washington, no good.
Hard to figure out how he doesn't knock that one down. No defender in sight.
Here's Tatum. That's in the short one. Tatum's got 21.
Another one from Tatum. I mean, boy, this kid, he's cooking at the offensive end.
Napier dishes to Bryant. Back to Napier. That's good, and it's Bryant with the assist.
Oh,
great production on the interior right now. Straight from inside.
The Celtics have gotten more than 58% of their attempts to go down for them in the fourth quarter. They're 7 of 12. Cantor trying to free himself up, and that one is good. 32 points for Nash.
And they're really in a good position here, thanks in part to the way he's been able to score the basketball.
Brown against Hayward. Bryant has the open look. Drains it from beyond the arc.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Yeah, and they aren't just chucking up anything. I mean, they're doing a great job of creating quality looks.
It's stolen by Brown. And here comes Brown, leading the fast break. The feed now to Bryant. Makes it off the glass. Bryant's got 5 points in the quarter.
Once he turned it on, he became a force in this game. Not sure where this guy was in the first half.
Here's Jay, and it's
purée, à chaque fois. Chaque fois, je me fais bâche.
Tatum against Beal. Over Tatum. Beal can't get it to go. Austin leading by 23. Hayward goes in, and that one drops.
Look, good size and underrated athleticism. Hayward's able to muscle through the contact.
Napier with it. And the layup's good off the glass.
How about this turnaround? He played a fringe role.
Comment ça, time out, Celtics?
And now he's the man for them.
Pas besoin, les gars, tout se passe bien.
And with the likely return of prep to pro prospects, Chris, some have argued for a high school combine to help determine who's ready to make the leap and who isn't.
I'm not really there with the high school combine. I still think that, you know, you still have a level of college or a level of professionalism that can happen after. And I don't believe until you're ready to be evaluated for the pros immediately, should you have that combine. Your bodies are still growing. I talked to Jaren Jackson just yesterday, and he told me that he grew 2 inches over last summer. So I think it's a little unfair to judge these guys that early when their bodies and mentality still has a lot of development left.
Down low, here's Brown. Another possession, another assist.
That makes 15 assists.
He's been one step ahead of the defense all game long. Napier with it. Jay's there. Napier, again the Wizard score.
Taking things into his own hands. He's been a beast this quarter.
Jay passes to Cantor. And there are the Celtics with another basket.
And it's coming easy for them right now.
Ouais, ça se passe grave bien en fait.
And so Napier will bring it up for the Washington Wizards. Pass to Beal.
Ah oui, les Bulls, c'est vrai aussi que on avait fait un gros score contre la dernière fois.
Stolen by Cantor. And Nash with a clear path to the hoop. Plays it in off the breakaway. Nash has got 34 points.
Wow, unconscious has he been this quarter. They're riding that hot hand.
And the pass to Beal. Lays it up off the glass. Beal's got 26 points.
Oh, you love how Beal rises over the D. He loves out muscling them at every turn.
Jay outside. Tatum on the wing. It's picked off. Here's Napier. Finished off the break.
Ouais. Bah en fait, j'ai voulu donner la balle au milieu, il m'a donné la balle sur le côté. J'ai pas compris, mais
any coach happy. Aggressive defense then changing ends quickly.
Feeds it to Tatum.
Oh, le bash de Tatum. Enfin, c'est Tatum qui s'est fait bâcher. C'est pas Tatum qui a bâché, mais c'est comme il s'est fait bâcher.
Of DC love the team as well. There's something special about playing in the capital.
Here's what Boston's going with right now.
Oh, il va.
Williams comes in for Cantor. And Brad Wanamaker subbed in
voilà.
Gordon Hayward.
And here's on se fait bâcher, il se fait bâcher.
And Wanamaker gets it to go. Wanamaker's got his first bucket of the night.
And this is why coaches talk about playing with pace. The scoreboard tells it all.
Yeah, because it's so hard to prevent transition scores. Whenever you get an opportunity to get out and run, take it.
Knocks it loose. There's Schofield. Shot clock at 5. It's hauled in by Brown. 1:14 left in the fourth.
And one team is just completely outclassing the other tonight. Spirited performance, and it really ignited what is turning out to be a monster win here for Boston.
This was a team performing to its
Ah non, faute. J'ai fini. J'ai pas fait gaffe, j'étais à 6 fautes. Oui, il ne restait plus rien de toute façon.
They've got such talent at that position. They'd love to have him out there, but they won't suffer much of a drop off.
And so it's Boston easily grabbing this one.
Homme du match en interception. Ouais, ça s'est bien passé. Petite interview, comme d'hab.
Hey, this is the Jet here, man. Your fingerprints was all over the game, particularly on the offensive end. What weren't they doing defensively that allowed you to take over?
Qu'est-ce qui vous a permis de prendre l'ascendant sur la défense? Cette défense m'a rappelé un bon Gruyère.
We just wanted to stay flexible instead of forcing things. We wanted to take what the defense gave us. When I didn't have a shot, I tried to make the smart, simple pass. I mean, we have so many great scorers on this roster, man. The last thing our team needs is me taking air out of the ball.
Well, you didn't take air out of the ball, you just took it out the net.
Hey, Che.
Yo.
They want you in the press room.
Okay, I'll be in there at 10, all right?
Thanks.
Dans la salle de presse. Encore des interviews.
Great game tonight, Che, especially on defense. Can you talk a little bit about that side of the ball?
Sure. I mean, I take a lot of pride in my defense. That's just who I am. I enjoy going out there and taking away what the other team is trying to do.
And how were you able to do that tonight?
I can't give away the recipe to the secret sauce, can I? How do you think McDonald's got so big?
Aggressive expansion.
No, it's the sauce, all right? The sauce, trust me, and I got the sauce.
Studio de capture de mouvement 2K. Capture de mouvement de NBA 2K 21.
Man, I saw your dog in the lobby.
Jay, what's going on, man? Looking good.
You know, I might rock this to the ESPYs.
Yeah, I think it's a little techie, but I think you should check out with Russ and see if he would be all right with that.
You're right.
Let's do this, man. I'm so glad to have you here. Obviously, you're the 2K cover. Congratulations on that.
Oh, thanks, man. I appreciate it, man.
Yeah.
So, what do you want me to do?
Yeah, we're going to run through some shots. We're going to get your jump shot, layup, and dunk. Let's start with that jump shot.
Okay.
I think you're in a pretty good spot. I'm going to back up over here. All right, mocap ready, and action.
Qu'est-ce que je dois faire?
And cut. Wow, that looked great, man.
Appreciate it, Ron.
C'est un tir en suspension.
All right, we got to get a layup. Let's make that happen.
C'est parti.
All right, mocap ready, and action. Great, man. Great. Just need one more thing. I gotta get a dunk.
Anything in particular?
Oh, man. Just make it as Che as possible.
Oh, for sure. You heard me?
Quoi, un dunk? Je sais pas dunker?
All right. Mocap ready. And action. And cut. What was that? I was looking for a dunk.
Hey, my bad, Ron.
Oh, man. Just move it along. Nice job, dude.
Oh, man, I feel like I really didn't nail it, you know?
No, it was good. Look, we're going to clean it up in post. It's a video game after all.
Sure.
Hey, nice job.
Thank you, man.
Hey, you're going to love that cover.
For sure, man. Yeah, yeah, you the man. You got it for me.
Yeah, we got to ROM you out.
Oh yeah, the lady Alex in the back told me I'd do that too.
Yeah, A right, pose, cool. T pose.
T pose like stuff. This?
Yeah, that's cool. T pose.
How long is it gonna take?
The alphabet A.
Hey, what's that face ROM I did? I didn't like that face ROM.
Bah ouais, les mecs ils m'ont demandé un dunk, mais mon bonhomme c'est pas dunké. Oula! C'est. Ouais, qu'est-ce qui se passe? Ah! J'ai eu 4000. On va faire un petit entraînement, vite fait. Pardon.
Stay focused on your workout. Let's get to work. Here's what we're gonna do.
Up, fellas. Let's go over the game plan. We need to be a sound defensive team, and that starts with limiting fast break opportunities. All right, let's go.
Donne-lui la balle, voilà. Merde, j'ai pas vu que mon bonhomme était de l'autre côté. Enfin, pas mon... Celui sur qui je devais défendre.
Thank you.
pas possible. Ah oui, t'es resté trop longtemps dans le truc. Ouais, j'ai mal géré, j'ai laissé passer. Ouais, bientôt, très bientôt. Je sais pas, je regarderai après l'entraînement, mais je dirais... Ouais, entre 6 et 8 matchs. Oh non! Vas-y, laisse tomber. Ouais, peut-être 6 matchs. Ah, t'as déjà fait 12 matchs. Là, je sais pas si t'as vu, je viens de faire un événement touquet. J'ai fait de la mocap. Non, pas possible. Sur les trois trucs qu'ils m'ont demandé, il y en a qu'un que j'ai pas réussi à faire. M'ont demandé de faire un dunk, mon bonhomme il est pas habilité. Ah, bientôt un nouveau batch. Oh là là, c'est pas possible ça. Oh.
fellas. Try to stay a while and get some additional reps in.
Enfin, à un moment donné, je vais pouvoir dunker, mais là, c'est parce que ma barre n'est pas... J'ai une barre de dunk, en fait, et je... elle est pas montée, elle est à... Je sais même plus. Mais elle est trop basse pour qu'il dunk. Un jour, peut-être. Chaque fois trop tôt. Ça va venir.
Get to work is what we're gonna do.
Il est vraiment pas le timing. Ouais, regarde-moi ma barre de dunk, elle est là. Je suis à 35 en dunk. Si tu veux que je dunk avec 35 et sans élan, je suis à 25. Hein. Allez. On va affronter les Bulls. La dernière fois qu'on avait affronté les Bulls, ça s'était bien passé.
Welcome to this week's episode of NBA 2K TV. Let's get right into it. We have the winners of the first ever NBA 2K20 Shoe Creator Challenge.
That's right. Not only are we going to announce who you voted for.
Bam, j'ai réussi, j'ai mis maybe. Et on joue ce soir à la maison ou...
The Chicago River winding its way through the
heart of
the city, our site tonight.
On joue au Chicago.
We welcome you to DA. It's all... Well, it can be a circle. David Banks. And a look here at the scoring trend over the last several months for Che.
And he's been on the upswing offensively these past few months. And you know how much they love getting all those extra points out of him. He's been carrying a much bigger load lately, and I think he'll just continue to get better.
And now the opening lineup for Boston. Brown and Hayward, they're the wings. Tatum and Cantor together down low. And it's Nash in at the one. And for the Bulls, Levine at the two with Porter at the three. Markkanen and Carter are up front, and it's White in at the point. Steve, compare it now to when you were playing. Did teams go deeper into their benches than they used to?
Yeah, they do. I think because of this load management, resting players. So you see a lot of guys play a lot. And also what they've done right now with the G League, being able to bring guys up, they use those guys. And I think it helps a lot, even not on games, but in practice. You'll see more guys are involved in giving guys rest.
Yeah, that makes sense. So the Chicago Bulls able to put up the first points on the board. Tatum with it. 23 points for him the last game against Washington.
A guy who has lived up to lofty expectations. Tatum impacts the game across the board.
Pass to White. That's tipped. One-on-one fast break. Here's Nash. Unable to get that one. Ice D from
Putain, je l'aimais même pas.
Chicago with the ball. Last meeting was in Boston, where they were unable to fight off the Celtics.
And it's going to come down to effort tonight. Last time they met each other, they were demolished on the boards, and that rebounding difference led to a sizable loss.
If you don't have that one guy who gets you 10-plus boards every night, you just have to send more guys to the glass. Excellent timing on that play and a wonderful pass.
The Bulls are gone, 2-3 here to start out the game. Levine kicks to Porter. Markkanen against Tatum. Levine deciding where to go with it. Lock at six. And that one's good by Porter.
Off the catch. That's when I feel like Porter is most in rhythm with his shot.
Passes it to Cantor. First quarter of ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. Nice ball movement by Boston. Left side, Tatum. His second shot goes in, off to a good start, 2 for 2.
Yeah, and I love how strong Tatum is finishing through the contact there. He's shown a real toughness in terms of when he gets in attack mode.
Bulls shooting their first shots of the night from the charity stripe.
And typically a strength of theirs, 79% on the season.
He's perfect from the line this time.
Ouais, c'est le début du match et je joue mal. Mais ça va bien se passer.
Great collection of talent and their core players are all very young and improving.
Now here's Jay. He picked up 36 points in their last win against Washington.
We also got to mention what he did on the defensive end. Racked up a number of steals, too.
Well, normally, it isn't a big deal when the players arrive at the arena. But Greg, Shane, and his suit were the talk of the entire pregame. Greg, I know you had some thoughts on that as well.
Well, Kevin, the term is drip too hard. And feel free to use that. Jay making headlines with his fashion statement to the game. And I wouldn't be surprised if this starts a style trend amongst NBA players.
Hustle points. count just like any others. That's a great play.
White the pass to Levine. And Cantor pulls it down. Cantor's got his fifth rebound in this one. And Steve, for the Bulls fans, their hopes lie in their young core.
Totally agree. The Bulls should focus on developing that core. Have a good blend with Levine, Markkanen, and Carter. They just need to keep their eye on the prize.
Now here's Che. And you know the points will always be there for him. He's averaging just a shade under 20 points a game right now. So the Bulls, the last game, a win against the Heat.
And what an outstanding win it was. I mean, to get it the way they did in overtime made it that much sweeter.
They show real guts nabbing that victory in overtime. No doubt they are a better team because of that one moving forward.
Yeah, attacking the interior is something White does well. He's crafty, and he makes good adjustments against the defense.
Now here's Che. The pass to Cantor. Tatum wide open. He fires one. Bangs home the trifecta. Tatum's got 7 points in the game.
And really an advanced feel for scoring the basketball. Tatum picks and chooses his shots nicely.
White finds Carter. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
And even as a rookie, you could see the consistency game to game from Wendell Carter. Very dependable on the glass and on the scoreboard for a player so young.
And with Carter, he's only going to get better over the years.
The upside is easy to see. He always finds ways to contribute to this team. Not sure if he'll be a star, but he'll be a rock on the offense and defensive end for a long time.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
White, wide open. He fires. Great positioning on the putback.
Right there, Carter using his instincts and
mobile
to track down the miss.
On se reprend là.
Second chance points.
Now here's Jay. Brown outside. Let's a floater go. It's hauled in by the Bulls. Carter's got 4 rebounds in this game.
Les yeux sous dehors. Ouais, non, là, ça va plus. Ça va plus.
Celtics trail by 3. Che outside. Here's Cantor. And Cantor throws it down.
Doing his job on the glass and doing it with force.
And Greg, it's not everybody in the league who can make those kinds of plays.
You know, this is one of his specialties, keeping plays alive, creating second chance opportunities.
Alley-oop.
That's why Hayward is considered a complete basketball player.
Ça fait plaisir,
en alley-oops. Can get up for these alley-oops.
And White kicks to Porter. On the wing, Levine shoots over Brown. There's Markkanen. Count it. Good. Markkanen's got his 3rd basket of the night right there.
They are just killing him on the interior.
Che outside. Right side, Tatum. To the inside. Cantor laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Cantor's got 6.
Good job of stepping up to the plate there, seizing back the momentum for his team.
That's the competitor in him. Close game. Let me have this one.
Now here's Porter. 20 points for him last game against Miami. Pass to Levine. White with it. Now guarded by Tatum. Here's Markkanen. Good. Nice job down low. He's got 8.
I will say this about his shooting stroke. It's pure when he's got it going. Perfect so far this quarter.
Nash, the pass to Brock. Back to Nash. In the corner, it's Hayward. Let's it go with a 3. He can't hit that time. And the Bulls going the other way now. against Porter. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. Pass to White. Pulls it up. Pulled the shot a little left, but the bounce goes his way. And now a three-point Bulls lead. Jay outside. Harkin on the double team. Here's Nash. Out of hand on it.
And for marketing, contesting shots is not about explosive athleticism. It's about being in the right position and timing it right.
For three, Levine. Here's White. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. It goes on Jason Tatum.
Non, là, ça va pas. D'habitude, les boules, on les prend, comme on dit, et là...
On the court right now for the Celtics. Tatum and Kanter together down low. Brown and Hayward, they're the wings. And it's Jay in at the point. Levine kicks to center answer. And the Bulls with another miss. Celtics trail by eight. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
And every so often, Steve, we'll see two teammates fighting over a rebound. Do you ever have a teammate upset with you for stealing his rebound?
A lot, Kevin. All the bigs I played with, those guys hated when guards came in. They would elbow you, and if you were on their same team, saying, get out of here, especially for a lot of those bigs. It was a lot of rebound incentives in their contract, so they wanted to grab every rebound.
Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. Shai, in the last game against the Wizards, put on a show. He scored 36 points, and his passing was just incredible. He piled up an impressive number of assists. His numbers were off the charts. He was unguardable, and he knew it, and he took advantage of it. Kevin, back to you.
Thanks, David. Greg, it was obvious he was having a lot of fun out there. Tremendous victory.
I'll tell you, he may have been enjoying himself, but whoever was matched up against him certainly wasn't.
What I like is they just kept calling his number. Sometimes we see coaches go away from what's working, and we wonder why.
Hayward can't hit.
And hard work on the glass. Once again, guys, they put a lot of effort and focus on the backboard.
Outside, Porter. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
Well, the former Georgetown Hoya, Otto Porter, was on the move last season. Traded at the deadline to Chicago, who are in need of a player like Porter who can shoot from outside.
Nash, the pass to Brown. And finished off by Brown.
Staying open to what develops, one of Che's biggest strengths as a playmaker.
Chicago leading by eight. Now here's Satoransky. His last outing, 16 points for him. Right side, Porter. Passes it to Levine. Five on the clock. And again, no good by Chicago. Smitty, as you mentioned, the need for shooters was something that brought Porter here.
And Porter has been a consistently good shooter, something he's worked on over his career, Kevin. He's young and appears to be a perfect fit for what this team wants to do in the future.
Carter kicks to Satoransky. Outside, Levine. On the three off target.
Can you believe it? He's missed every shot he's taken. Yet this team still continues to hold the lead.
On the wing, Brown. Good, and the assist goes to Nash. Shaves got three assists in the game.
And Brown is so aggressive, a masterful penetrator who abuses defenders on the drive.
Here's Satoransky, and Kanter pulls it down. Kanter's got rebound number nine now. What an effort here tonight. Yep, that one goes in there. 9 points for Jason Tatum.
And the skills of Brown, not just a super athlete, but a tremendous floor general as well.
Satoransky looking around. Porter trying to free himself up. Satoransky gets the bucket. Satoransky's got eight.
Excellent move to score the basketball despite a weak hit.
flash against Satoransky. Here's Kanter. Carter pulls it in. Carter's got his fifth rebound right now in the game.
And they're controlling the boards, Kevin. That's plus five in that category.
Yes, that goes in.
He's able to do this now because of the added strength. Porter muscling it home.
Satoransky against Nash. A three. Carter pulls it in. Last game for the Celtics, they pick up the win against the Wizards.
Well, in that one, they just had everything working offensively. It's a lot of fun when you get into that kind of a groove.
You know, I love what the coaches did tonight. They pushed the right buttons time and time again.
Markkanen finds Porter. Two free throws coming up.
Ah, là, je l'ai vu, la faute. Bon, c'est pas moi qui l'ai fait, mais j'ai vu qu'il allait avoir faute.
Yeah, it's something that his former coach Scott Brooks was always trying to promote to Porter. When he becomes more than just a catch and shoot threat, that's when his game is at his best.
White, he's checked in for the Bulls. Brad Wanamaker is checked in for Boston. Here's Carter. The shot will not fall. Excellent D from Kanter. Nash, the pass to Tatum. Nice ball movement by Boston. Shea outside. No good on the three.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
Levine passes to Markkanen. That's good, and it's Levine with the assist. Levine's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
It's Brown on the wing, guarded by Porter. And it's Brown missing.
Another rebound hauled in. They're hitting the glass with a lot of passion.
Outside, White. Three-pointer.
Oh no, le green.
And now he's shooting at a 5-for-8 clip.
Beautiful find by Levine there. Takes his time to survey the floor.
Here's Wanamaker, guarded by Levine. Wanamaker misses.
Those are chances. Almost always you can rely on him to get you 2 points, but the D just enough to keep him out of rhythm.
Brown kicks it over to Nash. There's the three. It's hauled in by the Bulls.
In this first half, he has really fallen in love with the three. So far, not paying dividends.
White the pass to Carter. White with it. Now the pass to Porter. Here's the three. It doesn't go for him. Celtics trail by 11. Pass to Brown. Wants to get it to Tatum and does.
A terrific athlete at that wing with good bounce. Tatum, fun to watch.
White the pass to Levine. Back to White. Carter right side. Kept alive. And so it looks like the Bulls will retain possession here. Most of the season completed, a good picture developing as to the top rookies in the league. So let's take a look.
Ah, j'ai descendu au classement des rookies.
Rookie of the year. And you look at White, he's just not quite in the running at this point. And while he's had a pretty good season, it doesn't look like he'll be a contender.
And the crop of young talent coming into the league this year, especially this group, has painted a very bright picture for the future of the NBA.
Well, it's one of the most interesting things for us to watch, seeing how these young guys develop. And you're right, this year's draft class has been unreal.
Rebounded by the Celtics. Kanter's got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one.
I mean, all period, it's been a struggle for him scoring the ball.
White, good.
And that one started by the quick hands of Levine, then the good look up court.
Pass to Kanter. Tatum on the wing. And here's Jay outside. A second chance effort, and two shots coming up at the line as it gets fouled on the shot. And the foul goes against Chicago. The Celtics have gone 2 for 2 in the game. Outside, LaVine. From deep three-point range, and the last second attempt does not go in for him. And that'll do it for the first half of competitive games so far.
À 10-3, c'est pas... Non. Il faut, il faut que je fasse des passes décisives. The second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge.
The Bulls leading by 4. Knight and LaVine team up in the backcourt. Porter and Markkanen, the duo at forward. And it's Carter in at the 5, roaming the paint. So that's the 5 in the game for Chicago. Porter finds LaVine. Carter for 3. And Tatum pulls it down. Tatum's got 6 rebounds in the game. Nash against LaVine. Porter with the steal.
Oh putain. And here we go. Fast break. LaVine's got it. He climbs it off the back iron and down it falls.
When they go up tempo and push the action, they are speaking Zach LaVine's language.
White against Nash. To the paint. Here's Cantor over Carter, and he could not get that one.
Oh, la faute.
Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for 2. Steve, the league has broadened the definition of clear path foul. Think that'll discourage the wrap-up fouls that stop those fast breaks?
Yeah, I think so, because the guy's coming downhill with that type of force. And if you do wrap him up, and sometimes your coaches want you to because of the situation, but it's hard, and it can create a lot of injuries. So I do like the clear path foul.
And the whistle blows as the basket counts, and a three-point play chance right here. One free throw coming up.
Attacking with purpose. LaVine takes the contact, finishes strong, now goes to the line for 1 more. And with this team, Zach LaVine has been thrust into the role of the leader. Still young in his own right, but as a rising star and a large part of the future, responsibilities have fallen in his lap.
In the corner, it's Hayward. Just 5 to shoot. Over LaVine. That is good.
Dommage.
The Bulls lead is cut down to just 6 points with the basket.
Dommage, il s'est avancé.
Talented, driven. He puts constant pressure on your defense.
For LaVine, he is the best scorer on the team, and you know what, Smitty? He should be a leader.
You're right. That isn't something that's easy to step right into. After losses pile up, you feel more pressure and want to take over every game. Zach LaVine should be up to the task, but it will take some adjusting.
I'm a fan of anybody who defends that way. I mean, they weren't about to open the door and just allow him to cruise in for a layup.
First free throw is good.
The athleticism and blinding speed White possesses is
impressive. Putain, on va pas perdre contre les Bulls. Ils avaient éclaté la dernière fois.
Williams is checked in for Tatum. Passes it to Cantor. Over Carter.
Oh, joli.
And the shot is good. The Chicago lead has been cut down to 8 on the bucket from Enes Kanter.
I'm not sure if he was trying to show off or what, but when you're that open, you got to go straight to the basket. The fadeaway was clearly a bad choice.
Chalk up 2 there.
Quoi, t'as pas sauté, toi?
All cylinders here in the third. Only 1 miss in 5 attempts.
Down low. And Jay gets it to go on the assist from Enes Kanter. Shays got 12 in the game. The Bulls leading by 8. And there's the pass to White. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. And Boston with the rebound. Cantor's got 13 rebounds in the game. Class eating. In the corner, it's Hayward. Outside, Williams. From deep, Shay buries the long-range jumper.
Il rentre.
It's only a 5-point Bulls lead.
And with a defender right in his shirt, terrific focus by Shay. He's a hard guy to rattle.
And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Well, Kevin, there's not a lot of NBA players who come from Finland. Now there's Lauri Markkanen. Before him, there was Hanno Matala, who was actually Lori's high school coach. Markkanen is soft-spoken and family-focused, but he says everything starts from basketball. All the decisions I make are based on if it helps me on the basketball court. Kevin?
Terrific attitude. David, thanks. Chandler Hutchison, he's checked in for Markkanen. Levine, good. Levine's got 9 points now in the quarter.
You see Levine's filled out his frame, shakes off contact, and completes the play.
Poirier passes to Che, and he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed.
Le petit trou. La technique du petit trou.
Levine, who brings it up for Chicago. They've led by as many as 11 points. Doesn't go that time. Excellent D there from Williams.
And the truth is, this league would have been much bigger had he shot better.
He had stolen by Carter. Here's White. And it's off from three-point range.
He started off solid. Had 2 threes at halftime, but blank from deep since.
Yeah, this offense is rolling. They've been assertive, but they're also playing under control.
And it has them in a great spot to take the lead. They love to get a few stops now at the other end.
Here's Hutchison, still looking for his first bucket in this one. Shot clock at 6. Gets it to go from 18 feet away. And the Bulls lead by 4. Celtics have gotten 6 of their 7 shots to go down in this quarter. What a fantastic start to the half. Inside.
Oh, man.
And here we go. Levine heading to the hoop. Count that bucket.
Ma faute.
That's off contact. Really good body control. You like to see Zach playing physical.
Smart finds Hayward. Mash up on top. From the arc. And the
oh, là, là, c'est joli. From deep.
A much different player here.
Comment c'est joli ça.
He's taken advantage of what the defense allows.
And the Celtics rebounding well this summer from the loss of Kyrie Irving.
Dommage que je connais pas le timing parce que putain, je serais bon entre
autres.
And with their young core, understandable that they didn't want to extend Horford out to age 37. A revamped roster, but I think they remain a contender in the East.
And Smart gets the assist. Now just a 1 point Bulls lead.
In attack mode all evening, Che has carried this offense at times.
Here's White, here's Carter, and then Carter with the jam.
And those plays can make a difference in a game like this.
Well, you know it's going to fire up, Greg, everybody on that bench.
This is a close-knit group. They feed off one another's energy.
They didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
And White kicks to Porter. Carter outside. Pass to White. Lets it go. And he hits the jumper for 2. White's got 6 points in the quarter.
Beautiful find by Carter. Sees the floor really well for a young big.
Now a timeout called by Boston. There are certain players, as we know.
Ah, les dents, les dents, la minute t-shirt avec les dents, c'est
ça.
Ah, on m'a sorti.
And really, the form at the line all season has been terrific. 79% as a team.
And the free throw is good, now leading by 1.
Third pick in that 17 NBA draft after a strong rookie campaign. I think Tatum was going to be around for a while.
For the lead, no good on the shot, a bit long that time.
And they haven't been able to turn it into a big lead, but their rebound advantage is starting to add up.
Great job executing the offense. That pass on time and on point.
One 10 left in the third. Here's Satoransky, rebounded by the Celtics. Next up for them, the Knicks coming out here to play. That game will be a quick pit stop before hitting the road again. And slam dunk by Tatum.
Shifty, elusive offensively. Tatum's scoring potential is through the roof.
Satoransky, the pass to Levine. They double him with Jay. Back to Satoransky. And he dunks it down.
Big hops from the backcourt.
Oh, absolutely. And maybe just what they need to get this game, GA, going in their direction.
It's a tight contest. Those type of plays can fire up your team and swing momentum.
Now this is more like it. 9 points formed from 3 points.
Ça fait plaisir quand les 3 points rentrent.
Than he had in the first.
Harkonnen dishes to Levine. Porter passes to Levine. Count that one. Levine's got 16 points here in the second half.
Trying to slice into this deficit every time up the floor. Terrific quarter for him.
To the middle. Here's Jay. Markkanen pulls it in.
Oh, I don't believe that. He's better than that. Come on.
Merde, j'ai pas mis.
Porter, no luck. Shoots from the elbow.
Oh non! Oh le truc, il tape sur le rebond. Il tape dans l'anneau puis il ressort.
And now we have a moment to reveal our State Farm assist of the game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call.
Ah oui, c'est le alley-oop.
Yeah, you also have the location of.
C'est cool, c'est moi qui fais la passe du match.
Puts it right where it needs to be, where his man can do something with it.
We've reached the fourth quarter, and what has been a very competitive game should be an exciting finish. And a look at the five for the Celtics to start the fourth quarter. Round the small four with Tatum holding down the four spot. Kemba Walker is out there with Jay. And it's Cantor in at the center, filling out the middle. And
Ennis. J'ai tenté un jeu.
That will get him his fourth foul of the game.
J'aurais pu faire autre chose, c'est vrai. Of the
evening. He needs to be careful now. Pick and choose where to be aggressive.
Bounce pass Markkanen. Levine up top, guarded by Walker. Got it. Nice one there from Levine.
It's really been a tale of two halves, guys. A slow start, but this quarter, he has really been the man.
Jay passes to Walker. Back to Nash. Up and in on the layup. Jay's got 30 points.
These are big buckets. He's been instrumental in helping them try to close out this game.
And White kicks to Levine. Shoots over Walker. It'll go. The Boston lead is cut down now to just 2 points with that basket from Levine.
After a lackluster first half, he's taken charge offensively. We'll see how the defense responds.
Nice ball movement by Boston. Nash. That falls. Nice feed that time from Walker. 32 points for Nash.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
Pass to Valentine. Porter against Tatum. Outside Porter. He kicks it to Levine. Again, Levine missing. Celtics leading by four. A nice shot by Tatum. Tatum's got 25 points.
And they're scoring much more efficiently here in the second half, and they've gotten that field goal percentage above 50.
And Cantor over to help. Feeds to Markkanen. It's good for his eighth consecutive basket in only eight tries. Wow.
Since day one, there was never any doubt that Markkanen could score, but we didn't know he'd be this prolific.
Round the pass to Nash. Cantor with it. Guarded by Levine. Got him up in the air with the pump fake and then took advantage. And the Celtics lead by six.
C'est bien ça, il met ses paniers.
Clear breakdown in communication to allow that easy bucket.
Markkanen kicks to Levine. And Cantor over to help. Now here's Valentine. He's covered by Brown. A shot by Valentine, no good. Celtics leading by six. And they double up Jay. Outside Walker. They grab their own miss.
Bien, il était sur le rebond.
and the second chance points aren't easy to come back. It's all about effort and hard work, and he has today made it look easy.
That's a carryover from the way he played in their last game. All out energy plays on his way to a huge performance.
And that's a little lack of fight at the defensive end.
Absolutely. At least on that slam, you're right. That's one way to let a team back in the game.
Yeah, defensively, your mantra at this
point. Je récupère le rebond et je marque.
No easy buckets.
Pour les stats, c'est bon ça.
Nash against White. Uses the glass to finish the layup. White's got 27 points.
And right now, White, red hot. Just everything he puts up seems to go in.
On the wing, Brown. Wing shot on the way. Good. Nothing but net.
Right now, he's being too passive and not looking for his shot enough. He needs to be more aggressive and get more shots up because he's shooting well.
It's deflected. Tatum with a clear path to the hoop. And Shay with the basket.
Ouais, j'ai demandé la balle, et alors.
Tatum's got his fourth assist in this one.
A young guy with maturity, awareness, and a feel for the game. Tatum is special.
One sign of a great playmaker, hitting his man in stride.
Passes it to Cantor. Back to Shay. Tatum's shot is off.
That was excellent contest, preventing him from making something that's usually automatic.
And plenty of contact.
Jolie faute.
So, two free throws coming up.
And probably more of a natural scorer than passer. White has worked hard on his playmaking ability.
And coach Jim Boylan agreeing to a multi-year extension with the Bulls this summer, Greg.
And taking that interim tag off his title as head coach. Boylan, with over 30 years of coaching experience, afforded the opportunity to continue developing this young core. You love the pressure he's putting on them. Almost had that steal.
Fantastic anticipation. He has active hands. Even though he doesn't come away with the turnover, he's disrupting their offensive flow.
Outside, Levine. Back to White. Six to shoot. Levine against Brown. Levine can't hit. And here's Hayward. He'll bring it up for Boston. They've led by as much as 10. They get it again. Tatum kicks to Che. And they double up Che.
Mais pourquoi tu fais la passe à lui là-bas?
Over Porter. Tatum's shot is off.
Alors que je t'ai dit de le faire dans le paquet.
A shot by Carter, nobody around. Off target from 3-point range.
And they hold a huge advantage on the backboard.
Brown outside. The pass to Chain. Here's Tatum, light covering. Back to Che. Trains it from 9 feet away. Nash has got 38 points.
His shot making has been superb this quarter. He's taken over this game.
Carter, great pass to set up the lay-in.
A crafty score near the rim. Wendell Carter challenging the defense and prevailing.
And they double up Che, and he makes that one. And that's now 17 points for Enes Kanter.
Adding to this lead, he's been dependable and consistent at the offensive end.
Carter looking around. It's deflected. Shade drives in. Hayward. He can't get it to go. Ice D from Porter. Bulls trail by 8. And the foul called on Shade. That's foul number 2 for him. Here's Carter.
What I like, he hasn't stopped competing despite the off night.
Bobs it up for Cantor, takes the
alley-oop.
Dunks it down.
Oh, hole, and the lead gets bigger on a ridiculous offensive sequence.
That dunk alone would have been spectacular, never mind it coming at the end of an alley-oop. Porter kicks to Levine. It out to Markkanen. Porter trying to free himself up. Count it, and the Celtic lead has been cut down to 7 on the bucket from Markkanen.
From distance, Markkanen with the picture-perfect mechanics and the height to almost always get a clean look.
Here's White. No good there. Now the Celtics take it the other way. And the foul on Wendell Carter. That's his third foul of the game. Jay inside. White covering. Brown against Levine. 5 to shoot. Austin needs to get off a shot. Nash. And they
force
violation. Great team. And a chance now to take a look at the schedule for
si
the Chicago Bulls. On Wednesday. They'll host the Miami Heat, and then on Friday, they'll be matching up against DeMar DeRozan and the San Antonio Spurs.
And for the matchup with the Rockets, it's going to be an all-out battle. And you just hope they are rested and able to execute their game plan, as it's going to be a tremendous challenge.
And they double up Jay. There's the dish to Brown. A shot by Hayward, wide open. The shot's good. Brown making the play. Brown's got his 5th assist in this one. Bulls trail by 8. And here's Levine. Porter in the corner. Here's Markkanen. Great D that time from Tatum.
And the pressure he put on that shot forced the miscue.
Oh la 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 la, c'est magnifique.
Whether you block the shot or simply change it. Man, and Tatum gets up on these alley-oops.
Comment je lui fais ses stats à lui?
Ah,
les danseuses et le... Et la mascotte.
And the lack of rim protection, top of the list.
And it boils down to the question. Toughness.
Bah oui, forcément.
It, the other allowing itself to be bullied.
And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Jim Boylan talking with his team. He's pleased that they're getting consistent points in the paint. He said, in this league, it's not easy to do what you guys are doing. Let's just keep doing it until they stop us. Kevin?
Thank you, David.
Ouais. C'était mal parti, mais je fais un bon match.
Outside, White. Cracks in the tray. White's got 15 points here in the second half.
And you have got to honor White on the perimeter. Once he gets comfortable from there, it's going to be bad news for the defense.
Pass to Hayward. Now Cantor. 6 on the shot clock, and here's Jay outside, and the Celtics hit again from deep.
We've got a long range duel.
La réponse.
Jay taking back momentum for his team.
Levine against Brown. That's it, and the Celtic lead is cut down now to just 8 points with the basket from Levine.
About how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
And Levine comes to help. There's Brown with the three.
Oh la 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 la.
Taking 9 shots to get those 5.
Que c'est joli.
They have been relentless from deep, and you see the defense trying to react, but to no avail.
You know what? They talked about this at halftime, and they're doing a better job of creating space.
White with it, now guarded by Tatum. White dishes to Carter. Now Nash. We've got 108 left in the
ouais, j'ai cru. En fait.
Pass to White. Hayward with some nice D. And here's Hayward. He'll bring it up for the Boston Celtics.
And it looks like just playing the last bit of this one out. And what
Ouais, petite erreur, mais...
Yeah, they definitely ran the break well, a big advantage in that category, and they continually put pressure on the defense.
And this will make it 41 victories for them on the year.
And once they polish off this win, they'll be one more victory away from sweeping the season series.
And what a tremendous standout.
Oh, la faute.
High-level shot making, what we got a chance to witness. He responded to good defense with better offense time and time again.
So Chicago ends up going with a new group, and a new group in for the Celtics. Robert Williams, he's checked in for Cantor. Williams comes in for Jason Tatum. Green, he's checked in for Gordon Hayward. And Brad Wanamaker subbed in for Brown. Cornette can't get it to go. Guys, some great passing from him.
Yeah, everybody's touching it, and you're starting to see the assist
up
because the rhythm.
Oh là là, c'est gâché.
At this point. And you know, disappointment starts to set in a little bit. You fought all night, just wasn't meant to be.
Williams passes to Che. Back to
Williams. Mais non.
So we see Boston get the win here. A solid win on the road for them.
Oh, on a gagné.
The building was dead silent by the time GA.
And that's what you want to do. Take the crowd out of it by crunch time. Don't give them any chance to lift their team up at the
end. Ah, leur gars a monté. Et un nouveau badge en défense. Défense et rebond. Oh merde, si j'appuie pas, excusez-moi.
Kevin, thanks. Well, best of both worlds for you tonight, Jay. Your team got the win and you had that incredible third quarter performance. What got you so hot coming out of the break?
Qu'est-ce qui a changé pour vous à la pause?
Hey, you know, coming out of halftime, man, I just felt so rejuvenated. I wanted to attack them whenever I had a chance. I think they were caught off guard a little bit that, and we just let it snowball into a big quarter.
And that made all the difference.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again.
Has been the excellent play of my man, Chillin.
What up, Benny?
You got a minute, Che?
Hey, Pat. What's up?
I'm wondering if you're feeling any added confidence from getting your average scoring to 20 points per game. That's a significant number.
Oh, for sure. Every milestone like this is a reminder that I'm on the right path. So it feels good. And 20 points per game, man, that's always been the mark of a great scorer in this league. So it gives me a lot of confidence.
Good stuff. That'll really help me tonight. Thanks, Che.
No problem.
Oui, j'ai investi dans un costume. Je sais plus combien j'ai payé, ça. 5 000 ou un truc comme ça. Ou 8 000, je sais plus. Alors. Je mettrais bien un petit en plus. Attends, 1, 2, 3. Parce que j'ai 8, alors... Histoire de mieux chipper le ballon, quoi. Ouais, on va prendre ça. Alors, je vais compter tout de suite. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 matchs. En fait, je disais 8, mais non, en fait, il y en a beaucoup plus. 15 matchs. 15 matchs et puis c'est les playoffs. Généralement, je fais je ne sais plus 4 ou 5 matchs par live. Enfin par vidéo, ouais, par live, par vidéo. Donc je dirais 3 ou 4 vidéos.
To work is what we're gonna do.
Tout en sachant que ouais, après quand ce sera les playoffs, pareil, je vais enchaîner pas mal de matchs.
To work is what we're gonna do.
You got it, come on.
une moyenne. Une moyenne de 20 points, c'est pas mal, hein. C'est pas mal du tout. Ah, national.
And an inspired rendition of our national anthem. Really getting warmed up here, just moments away. We'll be back right after this.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Greetings, everyone. Our game tonight featuring the New York Knicks as they go up against the Boston Celtics in Boston. So for the Celtics, their last game, a win against...
Hello, everyone. Proud to bring you Wednesday night coverage of the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony and Brent. And let's check out a breakdown. Looking at some stats for Che.
The most positive thing about his last 10 games, the work on defense. His mindset has become very aggressive. The steals are up, and he's becoming a big factor on the defensive end.
So a look at our starters for the Knicks. It's Randle and Robinson at the four and the five. Peyton is out there with Barrett. And it's Harkless in at the three. And for Boston, Tatum and Cantor together down low. Smart and Brown outside on the wings. And it's Che in at the point guard position. And the basket by Peyton. Brent, at this point, perennial contenders sometimes coast to the final games of the regular season. Any danger that they can't hit that right button or flip the switch and get back into gear?
When you hear analysts say that the playoffs are all about matchups, they are exactly right. You and I talked about this, Kevin, several years ago about the time. Going into the playoffs, teams don't have to be hot. You don't have to be 10-2 in the last 12 games for your playoffs, because all of a sudden, if you're matched up against a team that's owned you all year long, your chances of winning that series are very, very slim. So it becomes just, let's get in and let's find out who we're playing, and then we'll get to work.
Brown, good.
Where Brown is at his best, a muscular beast who loves finishing strong through the contact.
It's stolen by Brown. And here's Che, 43 points out last game. The kick out to Brown. Right side Tatum over Harkless. A nice shot by Tatum.
And really at his best from mid-range. Tatum can create space and shoot up over his defenders.
Here's Peyton. Pass to Barrett. Takes a three. A rebound by the Celtics. This game coming on the heels of their win against Chicago.
And you gotta love a team that can maintain its composure on the road. Take good shots and knock them down with confidence.
Well, awesome to see in that last game how the motion in their offense didn't stop because they were in some hostile territory.
He hits the second from the line.
Well, the former Turkish star and third overall pick in the 2011 draft, Cantor is still trying to become a dominant force at the NBA level.
Here's Peyton. Excellent D from Cantor.
A lot of defenders choose to just back up off of him when he's in that tight, try to avoid the and one, and this time they're not backing off.
Yeah, and in one-on-one situations, Tatum is a nightmare to guard. Versatile offensively, it really allows him to score consistently.
Pass to Randle. And that time, also a missed shot.
How about the timing he shows there to challenge that shot?
And that's a guy that you can tell takes every possession defensively very seriously.
Knicks trail by seven. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions right now. They need a basket.
Now the pass to Harkless. Randle outside. Pocket six. Peyton outside. New York, no good that time either.
And so far, the team just 1 of 5 in that rim.
Oh, man.
Barrett with the ball. Now guarded by Tatum. Good on the bucket.
And credit Barrett for his
ma première erreur.
In
pas la dernière.
Nice job keeping his composure there in a tight spot.
Back to Nash. And it's blocked. And he's able to get it back. Passes it to Tatum. On the wing, Brown. Defended by Harkless. Brown, good.
And love how assured Brown looks taking these shots. His mid-range game is on point. He's squaring up like that.
Payton passes to Randall. Out to Payton for the three. That shot, no good. So the Celtics will take it the other way.
One player sometimes can drag down your offense, and he seems to be an anchor here in this quarter.
Poked away. Pass to Robinson. Here's Randall. A putback. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
Oh, what terrific hustle. He's got a nose for the rebound.
Craig, he's ferocious when the ball goes up. Down low. Kanter kicks the chain. Back to Kanter. It's Brown on the wing. Near the three-point line, it's Nash. And all around the rim that time before dropping in.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Here's the teardrop. Barrett, wide open, he fires. Misses the three.
Well, the D doesn't seem to be too worried about him from three-point range, and he shows us why still. I expect him to make one of those.
And the story here, Kevin, early on, is how well they've shot the basketball. Well, the big story from the Knicks last season was the surprise trade that sent Porzingis to Dallas. Shook up the entire roster.
Well, never easy to trade a franchise player, but there was some rumblings that maybe Porzingis was not going to stay there long term. And a surprise deal made last year as Porzingis exited New York for Dallas. So the next opportunity for them was draft and free agency, and to try to get as flexible as they possibly could be for the next few years.
Kanter kicks to Smart. Over Barrett. Here's Kanter. And he comes up with the deuce.
Like when his Julie, il était au bon, c'est bien ça. High levels of energy. Kanter is a monster on the offensive glass.
Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Well, I had a chance to talk with head coach David Fizdale. We discussed their defensive game plan, and he said controlling Jason Tatum will be crucial, adding he's a natural scorer, comfortable making tough contested shots. We've got to make sure that's all he gets. Kevin?
Thank you, David. Pass to Harkless. Smart with the ball. Now Payton defending for the finish. And slam dunk by Smart.
Pickpocket.
Well, that basket started with the steal from Che.
And so Payton will bring it up for New York. It's a 13-point game. Time call here. The Knicks decide to talk it over. As the teams head into this timeout, a chance for the coaches now to map out some plays for the next few minutes and a chance for the players to rehydrate.
Ah, la minute t-shirt.
With some Gatorade. That's important if they want to make sure they don't wear down later in the game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, you have to stay hydrated.
Boston making some changes. Gordon Hayward's checked in for Brown, and Walker's subbed in for Marcus Smart. Portis, the pass to Ntilikina, and it's Jason Tatum with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Celtics making a switch here. Williams is checked in. Outside Portis. Back to Smith. Six to shoot. Williams.
Jolie.
The amazing thing about Williams, yeah, he can block shots inside, but
Jolie Williams
out on the perimeter. His ability to play in space means he's more than just a rim protector. Doesn't care where you're shooting from.
Here's Johnson.
Really having a difficult time getting anything to fall.
New York, no good that time either. A drive by Chase. Good work there as it goes. Chase got six.
Excellent all-around performance so far, hence the big lead.
Well, if I was baking up a lead, I'd add two ingredients. One would be playing smart. The other one, playing selfless. They've done that tonight. Serve it up.
Inside, and a fast break now for the Celtics, and the shot goes in. 8 points for him.
I love his shot selection today. He set the bar for the rest of the team.
They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
To end the run, trying to get open is Gibson, and it's Smith missing. Celtics leading by 17. Here's Hayward. The shot's good on the assist by Walker. Walker's got three assists tonight.
And they have owned the paint so far, and the score reflects it.
Yeah, the bully ball tonight has paid dividends. Highly effective down there with the physical play.
Time call here. The Knicks decide to talk it over. Each team has a catalyst, Brent. Some guys.
Les pom-pom avec les juchers.
Flow of the offense. Is there one approach better than the other?
Obviously, great coaches, Kevin, are going to find what it is that their best player does well. And as many times as I could get my best player into that situation, that's what I'm going to do. So if it's Harden in isolation, James Harden's going to be in isolation.
Petite faute.
If it's Steph Curry setting off-ball screens and relocating for threes, well, I'm going to do that too. So it all comes down to a fit with the player, his skill set, and how the coach wants to use that best.
A pass to Poirier. Outside, Walker passes to Chang. That's him. That's his fifth field goal. He's shooting a hot 71%. 5-for-7. Knicks trail by 19. Hayward comes with the double team. Outside, Gibson. He's looking for Portis and finds him. The putback controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
And folks, he did not luck into that one. He knew just where he wanted to be to grab that backboard.
Right side, Williams. And stolen by Portis. Here's Ntilikina. Finished off the break.
Well, Frank looking better and better here. J'aurais dû lui donner plus tôt.
Austin leading by 15. And Walker kicks to Hayward. Here's Poirier. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. The Celtics working the ball around now. Shot clock at 6. Walker the pass to Nash.
The shot. Hey, c'est joli.
Walker's got 5 assists in the game.
He doesn't look satisfied with the lead right now. He wants more, and he looks like he's going to get it.
Here's Ntilikina. Covered by Che, stolen by Walker. And here we go. Fast break with Che. Jacks up a 3. It's rebounded by Portis.
A team's rebounding is a great measure of its energy. And theirs has been terrific here in the first quarter.
Time for some consideration in the passing category, maybe, Kevin. The shot is just not on. Get somebody else going.
And he recovers it. Che passes to Poirier. Che outside. Williams kicks to Walker. Just 5 on the clock. And they turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock violation.
J'ai pas vu qu'il m'avait redonné le ballon ou qu'il avait perdu le ballon et c'est moi qui l'avais eu. Mais bon.
Kanter finds Tatum. A drive by Che.
Ah là là.
That's just a good solid instinctual play.
Quand il me l'a donné, j'aurais peut-être dû shooter aux 3 points, mais j'ai pas voulu. Pour une fois, j'ai pas voulu tirer aux 3 points.
Oh, I love that dish down low.
Smart passes to Che, and he drops in the layup off the glass.
Che has 15
points. And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Now here's Peyton. 20-point game for him in the win against Charlotte.
He also did a masterful job in that game of drawing a lot of fouls, so he's creating havoc for the defense.
Clock back at four. Here's Harkless. From the top of the key, he buries it. Celtics leading by 20. Nash kicks to Cantor. Brown outside. To the inside. Here's Nash. It's tipped.
This has to energize Barrett. He needs to keep bringing this type of intensity to the defensive end.
The shot by Harkless, no good.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Jay, way outside. Again, Nash.
Oh, les mecs vont même, ils font même pas.
Harkless with it. Now guarded by Jay.
Comment on appelle ça? Au rebond.
Randall. Payton outside. Puts it up from 17. Second chance shot. Trying to get open is Randall. Robinson misses.
He's so good at getting to the rim. Maybe tries to get a little bit too cute with that one. I thought he'd lay it straight up and in.
A young guy with maturity, awareness, and a feel for the game. Tatum is special.
Here's Payton. And that'll be two free throws.
Je pensais pas que vous alliez faire une faute. Je l'ai un peu laissé passer. Je l'avoue. Je me suis dit, ils vont se mettre devant, ils vont sauter, bam, un bash, et puis voilà.
The shot clock resets to 14 seconds on an offensive rebound. Brent, you like that change?
I think digging into the numbers a little bit, Kevin, it only affects about 3% of total possessions.
Is that all?
Yeah, throughout the course of the year, not in any given game. So it's very, very,
no kidding,
very, very minimal what happens. But what I like is that your players have to reset quickly with 14 on the clock, and I think coaches are starting.
Bon, il l'a bâché un peu violemment.
Quick sets, as opposed to getting the ball to the top of the key and trying to run through a traditional set. Maybe you have quick sets after the reset to get yourself a better shot.
More strategy. Murray's checked in for Marcus Smart.
And working, Kevin, themselves to the line here in the second. A nice way to get your offense going.
Pass to Cantor. Tatum on the wing. It's rebounded by New York. This time they met in New York.
And they had to scrape and claw to get the win the last time these two teams went head-to-head. It came down to a few key free throws at the end.
Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, reporting from the sideline.
Thanks, Kevin. Che in the last game against the Bulls was terrific. He ended up with 43 points. And the energy he played with was amazing, willing his way to a double-double. Very solid stat line for him in what was a terrific outing. And you know he wants to keep the momentum going, Kevin.
David, we appreciate the update. Greg, we'll see if he can keep rolling here tonight.
Yeah, and that's the rub. When he's in rhythm, he can carry your team across the line.
And you want to see him make sure that the teammates are also involved in what they're doing, especially if he draws that much attention. Love his shot selection. Good at taking quality shots. Whether he's defended or open, he knows how to knock those down.
Voilà, je suis 20 points. Moyenne.
Here's the floater. And it's laid in by Payton. Payton's got 5 points in the quarter.
A soft touch from Elfrid Payton. A little tricky there on the floater.
To the paint. And Jay with the basket on the assist by Brown. 23 points for Jay.
And we're seeing some great ball movement out of this group, guys.
Oh non, faut pas ça.
This is his first foul of the game. When it comes to choosing, Brent, the MVP, the Coach of the Year, the Rookie of the Year, all these different great awards, do you like the current voting structure for these big awards right now?
I don't.
Oh non, je saute trop tôt, je me fais une faute.
Get away from what it is in terms of handing people.
Faut que je me calme là.
Figure out who it is that they think have earned those awards throughout the year, Kevin. What I don't like about the structure is that.
Allez les gars.
Media members who are voting on things that have huge financial ramifications for organizations. And when that stuff happens with a player who's going to earn a supermax contract because he made an all NBA team, what you're going to start doing is restricting smaller market teams from being able to afford the ability to keep their star player with the team. And so that needs to be fixed and fixed immediately.
I do not like the media. Wait a minute.
Wait.
I am the
media. You are the media, Kevin.
Strike that. Let's rewind.
Can we delete that?
They get a hand on it. Ely Kina looking it over. And the pass to Randall. Over Cancer. And Cancer pulls it down. Cancer's got double-digit rebounds now in the game. Here's Tatum. Robinson pulls it in. Robinson's got 6 rebounds here tonight. Pass to Ely Kina. Back to Harkless. Outside Robinson. From past the arc. A rebound by the Celtics. Cantor's got 11 rebounds in the game. Shea dishes to Murray. Nash the pass to Cantor. Doesn't go for him. And New York will come the other way. They defeated Charlotte in their last game.
Yeah, I felt like they attacked, but with a purpose. They knew what they wanted to accomplish coming in.
And talking with the coaching staff, they said in that game, they did a great job of not settling. Keep working the ball around, finding the best look.
Ouais, c'est cool, le 3 points. On était parti sur un truc un peu bizarre, là, où on n'arrivait pas...
Ely Kina got a piece of it.
That's good footwork from the big man. It's Cantor aware defensively to get to that one.
Ah non, mais n'importe quoi.
43 seconds left in the first.
Je le vois.
And it's out of bounds. The Celtics will take it the other way.
Je le vois, le mec qui est au milieu.
Bobby Portis is checked in for Julius Randle. And Damian Dotson subbed in for Maurice Harkless. Boston's gone 3 of 5 beyond the arc since the start of the second quarter. Here's Tatum. Knicks with the rebound. Robinson's got his 7th rebound here tonight. Here's Ely Kina. Props in the layup for two.
Ah non, j'ai pas réussi à l'arrêter. J'ai fait
4 points now in the quarter.
J'ai fait
Ely Kina wanting to be assertive and the coaching staff encouraging that kind of play.
Back to Jay. Good, and the assist goes to Murray. 27 points for Jay.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Here's Portis. Misses in close. And so it's Boston. Holding a very comfortable 25 point lead.
Oh, ça va, ça se passe bien.
Wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. Well, you look at Shea in this game, he has been everywhere.
And we saw just how important he is for this team in the first half. He was getting everyone involved.
Yeah, he knows his role. He's out there to distribute the ball, get his teammates involved. Nice job.
C'est tout ce que j'attendais. Qui est un deuxième défenseur sur moi?
It's Randall and Robinson at the 4 and the 5. Alfred Payton is out there with Barrett. And it's Harkless in at the 3 slot. Here's Payton. Excellent D from Cancer.
Well, they've been better than good on the glass today. And there is a glaring discrepancy between these two teams in that area.
And it's good for 2. 8 points for Jason Tatum.
They're getting on a roll inside. Their last 3 field goals have come from the paint.
Outside Robinson. Randall against Tatum. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up. And he's flourishing as a scorer. But Brent, how does Julius Randle take that next step?
Well, I think, Kevin, if he keeps improving on his consistency, shooting from that 10-foot to 16-foot range where guys are daring him to shoot and not wanting to deal with him driving into them. You know, last year he went up 6 percentage points from 35% to
40%. Oh la la, le mec, qu'est-ce qu'il fait?
16-foot range. You keep seeing that kind of improvement, the growth in his game is going to come.
And with a little over a minute gone, the second half is underway. Pass to Harkless. And two free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the contact.
Oh, les mecs font des fautes.
For New York, they have been getting it done to the line. 10 for 12. First free throw is good. No good on the second, so he hits one of two. Boston's gone 4 of 8 tonight from three-point land, shooting 50% on the three ball here. Nice shot by Smart.
How about that? Magnifique. Coming out to start the half. Je peux rien, je peux pas dire autre chose.
And so Peyton will bring it up for New York. Following this one, they get to host the Warriors. And that's the first game in a string of three straight at home. That's good from Randle on the assist by Peyton. And that's now 7 points for Julius Randle. Nash against Peyton, and they double up Jay. Brown outside. Back to Jay. Five on the clock, and that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle, and two shots coming up.
All of that earned right there. It's become Jay's mantra since he's gotten into the NBA.
And he's got his first free throw of the game. Both free throws good from Nash. The Knicks shooting at 36% on the night. They've got to step it up offensively. Peyton the bounce pass. Outside Robinson. Randle left side. Kicks it to Harkless. No good that time. Some solid defense from Brown.
Boum, je l'ai vu, le alley-oop. J'ai vu l'appel du alley-oop. Faut bien ouvrir ses yeux en fait.
Peyton attacking. And it goes down 2 points.
Peyton's got a pas sauté assez haut.
3 minutes gone now in the third quarter. Boston's gone 5 of 9 when they put up the 3-point shot tonight. Peyton against Nash. Nash drawing the double team.
Shoot. Oh, magnifique.
There it is. It's Nash picking up the assist.
C'est magnifique, ça, du...
Wow, 5 straight buckets coming out of hand. They are rolling.
Peyton dishes to Randle, and he floats in for the easy two. Credit the assist on that one.
You risk getting torched when somebody's open. Peyton's skilled enough to find the open man.
Nash drawing the double team. Down low. Here's Tatum.
And oh non,
trying to use the glass.
Mais non, faut pas foirer ça.
3 of 5 to start the second half, developing a nice rhythm out there. All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter David Aldridge.
Putain, je suis déçu.
Circumstances and time changes everything. In Dallas, Dennis Smith Jr. thought he was going to be the cornerstone. But with the arrival of Luka Doncic,
voilà,
everything changed. The promising point guard was traded to the Knicks. And Smith said it was
important. Je suis à 9, plus qu'un, et c'est tout bon.
Make the most of it.
J'ai fait mon double double.
New York, the ball is back in Smith's hands.
Ah, la minute t-shirt.
Thank you.
Oh, on m'a mis sur le banc. Ah oui, j'en veux une en troisième.
Nash outside. Pass to Poirier. And a wide open look for Walker. Off target with his three. New York's gone 2 of 5 with a 3-point shot since coming out of the break. Here's Smith. Slides through for his 7th basket in 11 tries.
Every player in the NBA can score. Smith Jr. has it going. He should look to score more.
Hayward with the ball. 8 points for him. That one is good. He's only missed one shot of his 6 taken on the floor.
Well, he hasn't missed yet, guys, and the defense is scrambling for answers to stop this hot start.
Smith drives in, and then Smith with the dunk.
I mean, he got to know that he can get up just like that. Wow.
Boston's gone 6 of 11 when they've taken the 3-point shot tonight. Very respectable. Back to Walker. Hayward on the wing, defended by Portis. lets it go from the wing. The shot's good from Gordon Hayward.
Cette défense qui était grande ouverte chez nous.
Unwilling to let up even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flames.
Yeah, he's the guy that you want to go to right now, trying to put this one away.
The plan of attack is obvious. Get the ball inside and go strong to the rim.
And Walker kicks to Murray. Looks for Nash, gets him now. Second shot opportunity. A nice shot by Poirier.
Joli, en plus on prend les rebonds.
Frustrating for the defense. You get the stop, but then fail to block out.
Yeah, that pops your confident balloon out there, just completely deflating when plays like that happen.
Ntilikina, nice work on the boards, paying off with the basket. Ntilikina's got 13.
Way to stick with it right there, as Ntilikina able to keep it going with the activity.
Nash, the pass to Poirier. Kicks it out the chain. His three-pointer's off the mark. Chase got one three-pointer tonight in four tries. There's 42 seconds left to play in the third. The pass to Ntilikina. Lock at six. Portis with it. And Portis throws it down.
Well, he's a pass first point guard. Ntilikina with a nice play there.
Here's Poirier. Now Hayward. That's tipped. Walker against Smith. And he finishes nicely on the layup. Smith's got 15 points here in the second half.
That wasn't easy. Dennis Smith Jr. with a high degree of difficulty on that one.
Knocks down the three ball.
Now, what a great option he gives them on every possession.
No good that time. And so it's the Boston Celtics.
Bon, allez, quatrième carton.
Up 29 points heading into the next quarter. The scoring has been tremendous, and they are shooting. And a worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
And how about the floor generalship right here? I mean, showing us why they're always in good hands when he's the man in charge.
Great hands, great vision.
Forcément, il passe du match, c'est une période canalée.
And there have been two very different performances from these teams today. As we get going in quarter number four, Shea is out there with Green. Then it's Williams. Then there's Murray. And it's Poirier in at the center filling out the middle. That's the Boston Five. Nash outside. Nash drawing the double team. Here's Poirier. The shot, no good.
Oui, j'ai vu, il était à droite tout seul. J'ai vu qu'après.
On the wing, Ellington. Started by Green. Been a few players now host podcasts, participate with those elements, with those vehicles
oh, putain.
The season. Thoughts on that?
I think it's great. I think it's fantastic for our fan base and for our players to have an outlet, to have conversations and share a little bit more about their personality. It grows them as people, I think, Kevin, especially I've listened to J.J. Redick's many times over,
yes.
And you learn something new, not only about players, but about their interests and how they're spending time. And I think if you were a young player, let's say you were a high school senior and you're going, or you're a college player, and you're listening to some of the things that guys are talking about and their experiences, I think it's invaluable for what it is that you don't know exists around a player in the NBA, and for you to start having considerations about how difficult the task is, how mentally taxing. So these things are great outlets.
Oh, c'est joli, ça.
Nash drives in, lays it up, and banks it in. Nash has got 31.
Down the stretch, he's been flat out awesome. He helped them get the lead, and now he's making sure they keep it.
And that kind of defense ain't gonna get it done.
Gee, we don't see those kinds of dunks out of him all the time, but we know he's got it in him.
Well, any guy can throw it down against air defending him. Plenty of room, so not so amazing. What does amaze me, though, is that no one came over to contest the play.
And so it's Murray with it. He brings it up for the Boston Celtics. 9 feet out, and Jay gets it to go on the assist by Murray. Murray's got his third assist on the night. The Knicks have gone 3 of 6 in the field so far in the fourth quarter. Here's Knox. Brent, when a team hires a new coach, what tends to be the feelings of the players in that locker room, knowing there's a new voice?
If you are a veteran player, you have the opportunity more than likely, Kevin, to call 5 or 6 resources that know who that coach is, because most of the time coaches that are getting hired have previous NBA experience.
C'est vrai que le dunk, autant le 3 points c'est joli, autant le dunk ça régale.
The biggest responsibility, Kevin, is that new coach trying to get as many of those players
into the facility or at a meeting
or at a dinner to have them understand from day one, as soon as possible, what
it
is that they're about, what it is he's expecting from them, and how it is he's going to go about them. Then all the other things about guesswork, those go away.
Right. All about communication.
That communication, and communication as quick as you possibly can. That's an important factor.
Here's Ntilikina. No good on the triple. Boston's gotten a positive outcome on 7 of their 14 three-pointers in this game. Not bad at all. Here's Nash. Good, and the assist goes to Murray. Murray's got 4 assists now tonight.
I don't know what's happening defensively, but they're not putting up any resistance.
Here's Ntilikina. They get the rebound. Robinson. And he battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket.
Just a grinder. Always doing the dirty work on the offensive glass. And that's one of the things he brings to the table.
Over in the corner, Green. Well, people talk about a player's mileage limit. Do you think total games is the most accurate assessment?
I don't think so, Kevin.
What is it?
It's the amount of minutes that players play.
Yeah.
I mean, there are plenty of studies out there that teams are digging around on that when players reach. And trust me, they got to be lucky, but you're talking 35,000, 40,000 minutes in the league. The body is just not capable at that point of replicating.
Non, je savais, j'aurais pas dû appuyer sur le bouton.
And you're out. So forget about the games. Go to total minutes played.
J'aurais pas dû demander la balle.
Find the biggest fall off for some of your favorite players that have amused and entertained you for years.
Interesting. And for Frank Ntilikina, some questions as to where he is best suited.
I mean, for me, I like when he plays more off the ball. I mean, he's shown that he could become a scorer when he only has to worry about that aspect of his game. Still very young and has a great set of skills with which to work.
And something about it, the game feels like it's slowing down out there for Che, who's seeing the whole court.
Stolen. Outside Williams. The dish now to Green. From deep, Che. Robinson pulls it in.
C'est lâché. The three-pointer has not
been his weapon in this one. He had 1 in the first quarter and still 0 here in the second.
Here's Che, and the layup is good. Che's got 8 points here in this quarter.
Opportunistic in his scoring opportunity was Che that time.
Ntilikina passes to Birch. Robinson kicks to Ellington. Brent, a lot of teams will be paying that luxury tax, and that is a tough thing for a lot of owners to swallow. Is this the best method to deter teams from going over the cap?
Outspending
smaller markets.
You're hitting the nail on the head, Kevin, because there are some teams, as much as you said it's tough for some teams to swallow, there are
other
teams
who
never see that pill.
Right.
And they're willing to
c'est
go as
du
far
possible.
As they need to go in order to put a championship.
Je crois que je suis à 82.
But the question you have for me, was it a deterrent right now?
Je crois que pour l'instant, il est 82.
It's as significant as it needs to be. We know the repeater tax certainly hurts some teams, but there are still teams that are willing to spend, Kevin. That's really tough on small market teams.
Ouais, je suis à 82.
Want to avoid that at all costs.
And New York making a change here. Randall's checked in. Here's Ntilikina. Can't hit that one. Nice D from Williams. On the wing, Green. Good, and the assist goes to Che.
Excellent play. Just adding fuel to the fire and really trying to put this one out of reach.
This is what great players try to do. They're not allowing the opposition to gain any kind of hope to try and get back in the game.
Here's Wanamaker.
Et ça rentre.
That makes 15 assists.
He's been one step ahead of the defense all game long.
Allez, shoot, mon ami. S'il vous plaît, monsieur l'arbitre, vous pouvez donner le ballon.
We're still waiting for that first and miss one from the line this half.
And so it's Smith with it. He'll bring it up for the New York Knicks. If you were commissioner, Brent, of the NBA, would you add or alter any rules right now?
Wow. First of all, I think you get to fly on a really nice plane wherever you're going, and you get to go to any game you want to.
Yeah.
So sign me up
with courtside seats, by the way, too.
Add or alter any NBA rules.
Ça, c'est dommage, on avait récupéré, on avait eu un bon rebond.
And there's not much that I think is out there for us to change.
It seems like All-Star Weekend and the length of the season.
Oh là là, faut pas le laisser tout seul, lui. Hein. S'il se met sur ce côté-là, c'est pour, c'est pas pour rien.
As far as the question, I guess my head was going to things that are on the floor.
I was thinking that too, but I couldn't think of anything that really.
On the floor, it's tough to figure out something that could be adjusted. And I know Adam Silver and David Stern before him. All of their concern mostly is about the optics of the game.
Yes, yes.
And right now, it's in a pretty good spot.
It's very pleasing to watch. There's no doubt. And they double up James.
Ah, dommage. J'ai donné au mauvais à la mauvaise personne. Dessus, les gars. Oh, dommage. J'allais dire joli, mais dommage.
Well, he goes in there and you're worried about getting bumped if you're a defender by Julius Randle, not the other way around. So physical.
Ça, c'est pas bien de dire des trucs comme ça.
And that one misses.
They're not doing themselves any favors with their free throw shooting this half.
Et après, c'est ça le souci quand t'es petit, c'est que quand t'arrives en dessous de l'anneau, il y a de grandes chances de se faire bâcher par tout le monde. Oh, il m'a volé le ballon. Joli. Il m'a volé le ballon. J'attendais juste qu'il fasse le rond rouge,
hein.
And the gamble paying off.
Here's Wanamaker, Ellington defending. And Wanamaker gets it to go. Wanamaker's got 11 in the second half.
And that's just cold. Blooded right there. He's taking no prisoners.
Confidence is sensational, and it feels like no one is going to stop him tonight from scoring.
And they've won the rebound battle so far, and it's translated to the scoreboard.
Yeah, it's not just about stopping the offense in the
second half. Putain, chaque fois, en fait, je fais pas gaffe.
Those shots are going to be missed, and they're doing a nice job on the rebound.
Je suis concentré sur mon bonhomme et.
In the fourth quarter, from long range, good shooting so far. Williams with the steal. Poirier passes to Wanamaker inside, and the layup's good off.
Sur mon, au coin de mon œil, en fait, je vois un personnage se déplacer, donc je pense que c'est un de mes potes, et puis en fait, bah, c'est l'arbitre.
Here's Smith, and the Knicks miss again.
Well, mid-range is where he makes the money, so when the D's slow to get out on him, always surprising to see him miss. From there.
Count it. 41 points for Jay.
C'était l'arbitre.
Attention on Jay. He's showing us that he can hoop.
Tipped away. And stolen by Jay.
Allez, vas-y, fais-toi plaisir.
Lots of room.
Ah oui, le mec, d'accord, je lui donne la balle, le mec fait la passe à l'autre, super. Et passe décisive alors.
Kind of get a team defensively on their heels, and if you can keep pushing and keep attacking, they'd never find some kind of defensive balance to help slow you down.
Ripped away. And he uses the glass on the way. Shea's got 43 points.
Zero
interception.
Take that on the inside. Shea aggressive on that play.
Passes to Randle. Shot to stop the run. Goes back up.
Ah bah oui, là oui. free throw good from Randy. Là oui, la faute. You know, the NBA not the only league with great players and great play. Talk about some of the other prominent leagues around the world.
There's some terrific competition. There's some great competition overseas in the Turkish leagues. Some very good players that play in the Russian league. There are some great players who are coming out of Australia, and we're actually seeing players now skip playing in the G League to go down to Australia yes. to start their development and professional career. So,
I perdu le ballon, j'ai trop. Kevin,
we're not joking around. It's it's a very real thing, and we continue to invite the best players that we can find, and they come from all over.
Shot clock at five, and the basket by Knox.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout.
J'ai trop fait le
performance for the Celtics.
And this was one that never really was in doubt, I thought, an all-around dominant performance. And you kind of thought that maybe even going into the game.
Yeah, there was a sense of that, and man, they just pretty much blew them right out.
T'as comment il me bloque, mon
clinic
défenseur.
Was put on display here today.
And so they'll be advancing their win total to 42 games.
And not only are they on their way to winning this game, this
also gives
them a win in the season series.
And you know, looking back at all the contributions tonight, it was
all-around
game for Nash.
Just does a great job of looking for space and then finding it. That's taking advantage of what the defense is giving you.
Birch kicks to Dotson. It's blocked. There's 21 seconds left in the fourth quarter. To Wanamaker to the middle. Here's Nash. That shot misses. Smith with the defensive effort. Pass to Ellington. And so it's Boston easily grabbing this one. And the outcome of this one was never in doubt.
And boy, they really put in a effort.
Ceci est fait. Orga et défense un petit peu.
Hey, this is Kenny here, man. You were phenomenal and a catalyst for this offense tonight. Talk about the responsibility of keeping everybody involved.
Elle leur permet de la responsabilité d'impliquer tout le monde. C'est mon style.
To be honest, Kenny, it's the heart of what I do. Everyone has a role to play, man. Mine is to make sure we just keep moving, keep working for the best shot. Because the struggle is definitely real, man. You can't afford empty possessions in this league.
No question, and the heart of the team, you are it.
Ah oui, mais c'est comme ça en fait. Je distribue tel un facteur et je m'arrange que mes potes soient démarqués pour faire le meilleur des jeux. Je suis repassé premier. Pardon, je suis en train de bâiller comme un gros porc. Ce n'est pas respectueux. Pardon. Et puis je vous tousse dessus, non mais.
Good game last night. Let's get to work. Here's what we're gonna do.
Ah, trop tôt.
Get to work. Here's what we're gonna do.
Ah, le prochain match contre les Rockets, ça va être tendu en fait. Ça va être tendu parce que la plupart du temps, quand j'ai joué contre eux, c'était tendu et j'ai perdu. Donc après, je me dis les retrouver en dans les playoffs, ça va être tendu aussi. Ah, hier, je suis à 82. Bon, bah, c'est parti alors. Joue contre les Raptors.
Congratulations to all of the winners, and it's time for you to vote again.
That's right. Which shoes do you want to see made in game?
And the Celtics looking dapper getting off the bus earlier. You've got to look your best coming into an opponent's building. And the game arrivals sponsored by Express. Dress like a pro.
The skyline of downtown Toronto really looking wonderful tonight.
Ils sont à 49 victoires et 18 défaites.
Welcome, DA, take it away. And the game is going global. You're right. Thank you, DA. Just a quick look now at how the point totals have looked over the last few months for Nash.
And it's really been a nice trend for him over these last several months.
He's been
improving in terms of his scoring output. That extra production making him more valuable the further we get along in this season.
And now the opening lineup for Boston. Tatum and Kanter together down low. Smart and Brown outside on the wings. And it's Nash in at the one. And for Toronto, Siakam and Ibaka, the duo down low. On the wings, Powell and Anunoby. And it's Lowry in at the point.
Ah oui, puis ils ont tendance à mettre tous les paniers qui tirent, ils les mettent. Hein, donc. Putain, mais c'est pas lui, c'était à lui que je voulais mettre. Je voulais mettre à celui qui était dans le milieu.
Penetrate. I love the bigs outside. I gotta tell you, Doris, there's nothing about the game I don't like right now.
I'm right there with you. Well, not exactly one of those big, burly power forwards, right? He depends on
his
leaping ability
more
than those
guys. Putain, j'ai pas augmenté mon pickpocket jusqu'à or pour qu'il me fasse des trucs comme ça.
We play just over a minute here in the first. A baseline J.
If you're going to play for this team, you've got to be willing to mix it up on the defensive end. And Jason Tatum gets in the space of the shooter. That's nice.
Brown outside. Kanter trying to free himself up. And so it looks like the Celtics will retain possession here. Just five to shoot. Nash outside.
Oh, joli le green.
That one's in his first bucket of the game. He's one for two. Well, Greg, you might know
joli, je le green.
But the rumor is that Jay will be on the cover of NBA 2K21. I mean, what an honor.
I saw some behind the scenes footage of Jay doing some mocap for 2K.
Ah, pied. Qui a fait pied?
That wetsuit covered in ping pong balls is comfortable. Great chance for Che to increase his presence though.
Three-pointer, Lowry, and the Raptors miss again. Boston's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Smart on the wing.
Mais non!
With the steal. Ibaka right side. And again, no good by Toronto.
All alone from mid-range.
T'as eu de la chance, mauvais.
Got a piece of it. Here's Brown. The layup missed.
Boy, if you're going up against this guy in this close range, you've got to
mauvaise passe.
Everything you've got, a tremendous.
On arrive à récupérer le ballon.
Now here's Lowry. 20 point game for him in the win against the 76ers in Philadelphia.
And then there was his passing. When he wasn't scoring on his own, he was making plays for his teammates, and they just couldn't figure out how to defend it.
Now Jay, after the missed three from Serge Ibaka.
Il shoot.
Tatum against Ibaka. Six to shoot.
Oh là là, c'est pas possible. Le mec pouvait shooter à 3 points, il l'a pas fait. Oh là 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 là, puis je fais des fautes. Putain, bah ouais, ils m'ont déjà mis sur le banc.
Facing that hostile crowd, they just found a way to kind of tune out the.
Et je reviens en deuxième.
And focus on the game.
Well, the best way to silence a crowd is with your offensive game. Those fans got quiet in a hurry when the buckets started raining down.
On the court right now for the Celtics, Hayward and Williams together inside. Then there's Murray. Then it's Che. And it's Wanamaker in at the shooting guard.
Ils viennent chercher la faute.
To look at the schedule for the Raptors. On Sunday, they'll be taking on Paul Millsap and the Denver Nuggets. Then on Tuesday, the Los Angeles Lakers will come into town.
And for that game against the Knicks, it won't be an easy one given it is coming on the back end
of a back-to-back, but they've been playing some fantastic basketball lately. And when you are winning back-to-backs, you're feeling good about yourself.
On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Oh, mais c'est pas possible.
In the last game against the Knicks was outstanding. He ended up with 43 points and seemed to pick apart the defense all night with a ton of assists. He put up great numbers and a terrific effort. It's not a game that anyone wanted to miss. And they'll be looking for a repeat performance tonight, Kevin.
All right, David, thanks. It's going to be interesting to see how he follows up that performance.
Yeah, he was the driving force behind that victory, but each night comes with different challenges.
What you love about this guy, though, is even when the defense adjusts to what he's doing, he'll make an adjustment right back. He is always ready with a counter.
And only 6 feet tall in shoes, Fred VanVleet's not the biggest, but his toughness, mentally and physically, is unquestioned.
And Kevin, growing up in Rockford, Illinois, gave him that perspective. Friends and family gone too soon. Basketball was the path to something better.
Just about a minute and a half has gone by here in the second. On the wing, Chain, covered by VanVleet. Out to Hayward, down to five on the shot clock.
No other way to put it. Just
Chain
a poor shooting performance for him, but luckily his teammates have picked up the slack. VanVleet
up again. It's good. Putain. And the Raptors lead by one. Il récupère le rebond chez nous, non mais.
Nice.
Williams passes to Nash.
Putain, je suis à côté du panier, je loupe ça quoi.
All effort on the rejection chain, never short on hustle.
Rejected by Gasol. And that one goes.
C'est moi qui l'ai bâché, je crois. Ça fait plaisir.
Surveying the D to the inside, trying to end the drought, and it's Jay missing.
I'll tell you, everything went right in terms of execution. He just can't get it to go.
From 13, here's Boucher, and there's the bucket. Staying with it on the offensive glass, getting it done. Boucher's got five now.
You simply must put a body on this guy. You know he's going to try to get to that glass.
Gasol against Williams. Back to Jay. Fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points. So one free throw coming up.
Et ça rentre.
Boy, what a motor. Scouts question Chase
Desai. Maintenant, faut que je le confirme.
No more.
The Celtics shooting their first free throw of the game.
Oh là, je confirme.
And really, the form at the line all season has been terrific. 79% as a team.
There's the pass to Ananobi. Here's Boucher. He's covered by Murray. Down low, here's Gasol. And a foul call. Almost got it to go.
Ah, la fois. For two.
As he enters his mid-30s, Marc Gasol showing no signs of slowing down. If anything, I think he's a better all-around basketball player.
Hayward outside. And Wanamaker has it in the corner. It's blocked. Closing in on 4 minutes played here in the second quarter. Here's VanVleet. That's in there. Davis with the.
Bah oui, forcément.
He's got five. And through his first 8 seasons in the NBA, Marc Gasol made a total of 12 three-pointers. Nowadays, Greg, he'll make more than that in a month.
And you ask around, he's always been capable. A great shooting touch. It's just a different job description for big men nowadays. Just such a well-rounded offensive player. He's got a little bit of everything.
Passes it to Davis. Again, Toronto.
and doing much better now. In that first quarter, converting less than 30% of their field goal opportunities, bouncing back nicely here in the second.
Back to Nash. Rejected by Gasol.
Just great timing and great awareness from Marc Gasol. This guy is a relentless shot blocker.
Davis with the bucket.
Well, you get exactly what
j'en ai marre de me faire bâcher comme ça. Sérieux.
Celtics trail by six. Out to the right wing.
Shoot.
Puis. And so Van Vliet will bring it up for the Raptors. They lead by six, their biggest margin. They'll host the Denver Nuggets after this one, and that will be the middle game of this three-game homestand.
Well, he's such a good athlete for a center. It's how he's able to succeed despite being one of the smallest fives in the NBA.
Nash outside. Poked away. Now the Raptors moving it up. Van Vliet with the bucket.
Pas possible ça.
And this offense is in a perfect rhythm, and you can see how they're finishing their play.
Well, what great game planning, what great execution. It doesn't get much better than this.
Time called here, the Celtics decide.
Qu'est-ce qui se passe avec le ballon là?
Having notched a win against the Knicks in their last game.
Yeah, they took advantage of some porous defense, and that one really got the shots they wanted.
Give them some credit. I'll tell you this, Greg. They caught in a.
Le jeu est en train de bugger. Merde, le jeu est bugué.
And you take advantage. Simple as that.
Ah, regardez, c'est moi qui me dirige. Ils sont perdus. Il y a eu un temps mort, mais. Ah non, ça a pas baisé mon jeu quand même. Enfin, disons ma partie. Ah si. Bon.
And so the big win by Toronto in a tight game. What a show they put out here at home tonight.
I mean, these are those.
Je suis désolé, j'ai dû simuler le match, hein, le match était bloqué. Et on a perdu. Bon, on va faire vite fait, hein. Je vais faire l'entraînement et après on va partir tout de suite pour faire les nets. Ok, l'entraînement est terminé pour aujourd'hui. Bon bah, vas-y. Hein. Il n'y avait pas d'entraînement.
Yeah, baby, I'm the 2K MC, and it's time to check out what's happening.
Pourvu que le jeu est pas en train de bugger.
This is Hank and the Hornet on 98.9 The Flex, the official home of your Boston Celtics.
Get game tonight. Ready?
2K Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
Bah moi qui voulais pas
simuler.
Mais j'ai simulé un match, bon bah tant pis. Hein.
The activity in front of the Brooklyn Museum, not too far from our setting today.
Les Nets. Ah oui, quand même, 45 victoires.
DA, it's all yours. Well, great story, DA, thank you. And now the opening lineup for Boston.
Bon, on est parti.
As finishes out there with Smart, and it's Cantor in at the five spot. And for Brooklyn, LeVert and Durant out on the perimeter. Inside, we got Prince and Jordan, and it's Irving at the one spot. And this late in the season, Clark, for non-playoff contending teams, really there's nothing to lose. The pressure is gone. You can let it rip, can't you?
Yeah, there's a freedom that you can play with when you don't have the pressure or the expectation of being a playoff team. And sometimes that allows you to play your best basketball because there is nothing to lose.
And so it's the Nets getting on the board first. Irving with the steal. One-on-one fast break. Here's LeVert. Here's KD, and a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. It's going to be on Shea.
And Durant finally captured that elusive first championship in 17 and the finals MVP trophy to boot. An effortless scorer who has also made great strides defensively.
Now here's Nash. 17 points for him last game against Toronto. Shoots. And there's Brown. That's good on the assist from Enes Kanter.
And if you're the guy,
ah, putain, je suis déçu pour le match des Raptors.
Irving passes to LeVert.
Je sais pas pourquoi ça a bugué. Aucune idée, mais là. Grave déçu d'avoir d'avoir dû simuler le match.
Sinks it after the KG pump fake.
Boy, I tell you, I don't know if there's anybody better than Kyrie Irving close to the basket. He has a great feel for how to score inside.
Nash kicks to Smart. Pass to Kanter. The Celtics working the ball around now. LeVert against Smart. Shot clock at five. And he gets the whistle for the 3-second call. The Nets have gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Smart against LeVert.
Les mecs sautent même pas.
You know, you gotta appreciate the speed of Kyrie Irving. I mean, incredible at finding different ways to get to the basket, and he is not afraid of anybody.
Now here's Smart. Last game out, he had 14. Oh, and here we go. Irving's got it. The fast break chance. Sinks the three.
Je me dégoûte. Sérieux, je me dégoûte à faire des trucs comme ça.
Kicks it to Smart. Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far.
Very rare for players to be elite defenders from the moment they set foot in the NBA, but that was the case for Marcus Smart. A tremendous physicality to go with a pit bull disposition has made him downright scary at times at that end of the floor.
Celtics trail by 9. Jay, high post. They need this. That one's no good. 0-1 to begin the game. Here's LeVert. Makes it off the glass.
Defensively, giving up far too many open rhythm.
Putain. Match qui vient de commencer, on se prend des jeunes branlés.
There's no other way to come back from a deficit unless you play good defense.
Encore tout à l'heure, ça. Et encore les Raptors, ça allait quoi, mais là.
The growth necessary for him has been at the offensive end.
And now, finally making progress as a three-point shooter. Had already made strides with his passing. He's becoming quite the two-way player.
Again, the miss by the Celtics.
Pourquoi je m'emmerde à vouloir tirer aux trois points quoi.
Durant down low. Brown's there. Great positioning on the putback.
And now you see them starting to really work the ball inside.
Celtics trail by 13. Jay inside. He's covered by Irving. He gets that one.
You'd love for all your shots to come from that range. Jay always going to cash in on a chance like that.
Irving with the bounce pass. Pass to Jordan. Here is Durant. Fires top of the key. Again, the Nets for two.
Oh, this is the kind of start they were hoping for.
Yeah, shots falling. Off to a very good start offensively as a result.
Here's Jay. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
Je fonçais dans le tas.
Boy, that's real concentration there, guys. It's one thing to finish through contact right at the rim, but for Che to do so outside of the paint, impressive.
Now here's Jordan. He's coming off a 10-point game against Washington. And it's LeVert missing. Celtics trail by 11. Che passes to Brown. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. It's Prince on the wing. That one a little long.
Nobody even close to him, and he can't believe he doesn't knock it down.
Basket good.
I like the confidence and the assurance that Brown is taking these shots with. I mean, his mid-range game is actually on point.
Now here's LeVert. A 14-point game for him in the win against Washington.
And he was relentless in that one. I mean, he wanted to be the first to every rebound and almost was.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
That doesn't go either for Brown.
Well, they'll be happy with that look, even though it didn't fall.
You know what? That's a confidence shaker for him, though. I mean, that's a shot he expects to make every time.
Now, here is Irving. He had 34 points in the win against Washington. Jordan, the offensive rebound. Last game for Brooklyn, they picked up the W against Washington. Back to Smart. Nash against Jordan. Nash, the pass to Cantor. In transition, here come the Nets.
Putain, ça. Je fais qu'est-ce que je fais là? Qu'est-ce que je fais? Allez. On se calme.
And you know that involves pounding it inside, getting as many points as you can right at the rim. That demoralizes the team.
Brown knocks down the 10-footer.
On se calme, on se remet dans le jeu.
Brown is just so physically imposing, I mean, especially inside where he usually gets whatever he wants.
Ah non! Il a repris le ballon.
Nash against Irving. Outside Durant, it's up a three. Rebound by the Celtics. Outplayed in the previous game on their schedule, losing to the Raptors.
You guys, you just can't afford to give away points from the foul line. Not in the NBA. Teams are just too talented.
Yeah, and you know, to come up short at the line is frustrating because that's controllable and it's actually a free throw. So you feel like you leave loose change out there when you don't convert.
And Irving is comfortable running the offense. When a teammate's open, he's quick to whip it around and get him a good look.
Now here's Che.
Mais non! T'es censé être devant!
Irving with a clean look. And Tatum pulls it down.
Allez, faut mieux que je regarde. Allez, je regarde mieux.
They trail by 9 points. And there's the pass to Smart.
Oh mais non! Tu pouvais l'accompagner jusqu'à l'anneau.
Outside Irving, the wide open look for Durant. A three-pointer, no good.
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time. And a great track record in the draft for the Nets. Karis LeVert.
Pourquoi je fais ça? Je sais que je vais me faire bâcher.
Taken at 22.
And you might want to throw in guys too. Rodion's Kurucs, the 40th pick in 2018, had a big impact, even participated in the Rising Stars Challenge. And you know, sometimes you've got to make your own breaks, make your own good fortune, and that's exactly what the Nets have done.
Now here's Smart. After Torian Prince's miss, Brown with it. He's picked up by KD. Brown the pass to Che, launches it. And it's Kyrie Irving with the rebound.
He's certainly been cold this quarter, guys, but trying to shoot his way back into a groove.
Che with the block.
Oh là là. Sans le vouloir. Putain, non, mais je me fais bâcher. C'est pas possible. Bah ouais, je fais. C'est facile à dire.
And then for Boston, Robert Williams is checked in for Canton, and Gordon Hayward is subbed in for Smart. Now a timeout called by Boston. Who do you think is the best center right now, spacing the floor, and also?
Ah merde, j'ai pas vu qu'on m'avait sorti.
And a breakdown here, guys. The hustle stats for the Nets.
You know, they've done a great job of getting a hand up on shooters. Actually, have gotten a lot of blocks as well, solidifying that defensive effort.
And also, they've been really active on the defensive end in terms of applying pressure and coming away with steals.
And season four for Coach Kenny Atkinson with the Nets. You've got to be impressed with the job he's done in Brooklyn.
Yeah, you know, Kenny is a hard worker. He's a bit of a grinder if you were trying to term what category he might fit into. And you see that in his team. And, you know, he admits it. He's getting better just like his players are. And that's a great, great statement because we're all hopefully getting better as we move forward.
On the court right now for the Celtics, Hayward out there with Enes Kanter. Then it's Jay. Then there's Murray. And it's Green in a guard spot. And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
J'ai cru qu'il allait faire un 3 points.
In the last game against the Raptors, put together a nice evening. He finished with 17 points. And he continued to connect from the foul line and the three-point line throughout the game.
Oh la 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 la.
We've come to expect during this great run of his. And we'll see if he can continue to stay hot.
Thanks, David. You know, GA, you wonder how much of that performance can carry over into this one.
You never really know what will happen game to game, but I sure wouldn't bet against him.
No, you can't bet against a guy like that. He looks like he's in a groove, focused, on top of his game. No reason that he can't keep it going. No idea what they were thinking there defensively. I mean, that's a shot he makes often.
Green against Dinwiddie. And stolen by Jay. And here we go, Murray heading to the hoop. And it's Murray with the jam.
Jay making it look so easy, dropping that nice room service dime there.
For Brooklyn, they've gone 3-7 shooting the ball here in the second quarter. And the foul called on Jay. That's foul number two for him.
That's his second foul of the first half. Not a big deal yet, but something to keep an eye on.
Here's what Brooklyn's going with right now. Jordan, he's checked in for Allen. And it's LeVert in for Joe Harris. Jason Tatum, he's checked in for Boston. Here is Nash, following the basket by Kyrie Irving. Here's Kanter. He kicks to Tatum. The feet to Che. And it's blocked by Jordan.
Putain, mais les mecs sont toujours là, quoi.
Stuff out of here. Take it home. Jordan is fantastic.
Non mais il y a personne sur lui. Bon bah c'est bon hein.
Rips down the breakaway slam.
Boy, dangerous on the fast break. Spencer Dinwiddie so fast and gets up and down quickly.
Deep chain. Here's Tatum. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
Yeah, in this quarter, they've had the right approach. Driving and drawing. Initiating contact. Create opportunities. Get to the line.
Yeah, I like everything you said there, because when all else fails, if you can get to the stripe, that's really a good way to change the momentum in the game, because you get points and you also slow down the opponent because the game isn't going up and down.
Oh non. Je fais une passe en hauteur.
On its way from Irving for two. That's good. And it's LeVert with the assist. LeVert's
bon,
fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Pass to Kanter. Smart against Dinwiddie. A 15-footer. That is good. And the Nets' lead is cut down to just 6 points with the basket from Smart.
And for people who would like to see Smart take fewer threes, that mid-range J is a welcome sight.
Now here's Irving. He's got 12. Yep, that one goes. Irving's got 14.
Monster quarter for him. He's put the team on his back.
Putain, ça va pas.
To the W.
Now a timeout called by Boston. Kyrie Irving really making a difference here.
You know, that defense is helpless right now. I mean, he's got their number and he knows it.
As we get a break in the action now, let's take a look at the East and how the teams are stacking up. Taking a look at Brooklyn, unless they completely melt down, they should be in good position for a playoff run. And of course, the Celtics, just a couple spots back.
And you know, for the Celtics, they've stayed right there, just just in sniffing distance of the conference leaders. That's a solid accomplishment at this stage of the season.
You know, I thought maybe they'd have it in them to actually join those leaders this season. But you're right, it's still nice work considering where they are.
We know you have great passion for the game of basketball. Any passions that our fans may not know about?
Yeah, I enjoy golf. I'm an avid reader, as you well know, Kevin. We actually share book titles on occasion. Obviously, food is universal, and there's nothing I turn down. I try to eat certain things in moderation. But I enjoy board games, too. In terms of sports, I'm a fan of football, both college and pro. Enjoy playing golf, and board games and reading probably are what occupy my time.
Great timing. He is one tough customer on that offensive glass. You know,
it's like he has a sixth sense of where that rebound is going.
And that sixth sense, guys, might be better than just about anybody else.
It's good.
That's why his teammates are always happy when Che's on the floor. I mean, with his passing ability, he puts them in great position to score the ball.
Now, here is Irving. 14 points for him. Over Nash, Irving, good. Irving's got 12 points now in the quarter.
Guys, his consistency in terms of shooting has really helped them seize control.
Nash outside to the paint. Here's Poirier. That one, no good. And it's the Nets taking it the other way. 13 points was their biggest lead in the game. Their last encounter was in Boston, where they were able to handle the Celtics.
And the last time they faced this club, rebounding was their big advantage.
Clearly, that was the overriding factor. A double-digit advantage on the boards. They just pounded them inside.
For a guy who's still working on his range, love to see Smart attacking on the interior.
Irving from long range. On his 15th shot attempt, he makes his ninth basket, shooting a healthy 60% tonight.
Boy, has he put his foot on the pedal here this quarter. He's doing a terrific job in terms of leading their offense.
Now here's Che in the corner. Tatum with it. Shoots over LeVert. Brooklyn with the rebound. They defeated the Wizards in their last game.
And that one was all about offensive execution, running your plays, picking your spots.
Yeah, you know, not deviating from the game plan is critical. You've got to trust in the system.
Now here's Jordan. Jason Tatum missing his last shot. Here's Irving. And Tatum pulls it down. Tatum's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. The dish to Che. Rebounded by the Nets. Irving's got his fifth rebound right now in the game.
He is just really almost playing for the other team. The shooting has just been poor. Coming off a big game, his confidence couldn't be higher, and coach knows it.
Showing no signs of slowing or cooling down. They're going to ride him as far as he can take him.
Now here's Che. Tatum on the wing. Nash, the pass to Poirier. Tries again. It's good. It's his second basket. He's shooting 2 for 4.
That's simply an outstanding play, working the size mismatch right at the rim.
Now, here's Dinwiddie. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against Washington.
And what opened things up for him was his passing. He was making so many plays that the D had to play off him.
Celtics trail by 15. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Passes it to Poirier. Good, and the assist goes to Nash. Poirier's got 6.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness, Greg. I mean, if they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
Teardrop shot, and there's the bucket as Irving finishes it off inside. Irving's got 23 points.
Yeah, you know what? Dinwiddie is very dependable at serving his teammates on the court. Seems like a natural leader.
Nash against Irving. Here's Poirier. That's good, and it's his fourth basket of the game. He's a strong 4 for 6.
How about that wonderful floater he has? Showing off an exquisite touch.
Irving passes to LeVert. Here now is Dinwiddie. Back to Jordan. A That's tipped. Stolen by Smart. Here we go. One-on-one. Here's Tatum. That one's in. His first bucket of the game. He's 1 for 2.
Man, I like the way Tatum plays through contact. Stays with his shot no matter what the defense throws at
him. Irving double team. Kicks it to Prince. Smart against Dinwiddie. Outside Irving. A three.
Putain, gêné par mes propres bonhommes.
Irving's got a couple of three-pointers in the second for Brooklyn.
Yeah, the D with very little pressure on their perimeter shooters. Three of the last five baskets they've allowed have been from beyond.
We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Smart against Dinwiddie. And Jordan sends it back. Dinwiddie, his scoring totals are something to take note of. He's averaging over 19 points a game. Irving from long range. No good on the last second attempt there. And so it's Brooklyn.
All right, Dave, non, ça va you. Pas, ça va pas du tout. Break.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. You look at Kyrie Irving in this game, he has been everywhere.
And the way that he has helped out with the ball movement has been a difference maker early on.
And you know, that's not a job they ask him to do very often, but in the first half, I thought
puis
he
lui
was
se met en deux.
With his teammates.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade for the second half of basketball. Setting the floor for the Nets. Durant and Prince make up the forward. Irving and LeVert are at the one and two. And it's Jordan in at the pivot spot, manning the middle.
Il met même pas son panier. Oh, tu vas me dire, il se fait bousculer, mais bon.
And he's been on the upswing offensively these past few months. And you know how much they love getting all those extra points out of him. He's been carrying a much bigger load lately, and I think he'll just continue to get better.
You know, there's no question about it. Tatum's ceiling is really sky high. Now it's up to him to meet those huge expectations, and I think he will.
And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim.
And you know, guys, I love his fight and grit on the interior. I mean, he never lets a shot go uncontested.
Nash against Irving. He drains the quick shot.
Ouais, je sais, je me fais trop passer.
And guys, once Irving finds that groove, it's really just fun to watch him go to work. It just no fear will take any shot out there on the floor.
To the middle and stolen by Prince. And here we go. Brooklyn fast break. Rebound Boston. Cantor's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Brown dishes to Nash.
Bah oui, bah c'est bien de me donner la balle. Vas-y. Oh, d'accord.
Back to Nash for three. And it's KD with the rebound.
Allez vous faire foutre.
It feels to me like this team is going to need more from him, guys. I mean, if they're to erase this deficit, he's got to step up.
The kick out to Irving. The Nets working the ball around now. Bounce pass LeVert. Deep. A shot by KD. No good.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
Durant with the steal. In transition, here come the Nets. KD's got the ball. And the upcoming schedule for Brooklyn. On Monday, they'll defend home court against the Orlando Magic. And then on Wednesday, they'll be playing against Lou Williams and the Los Angeles Clippers.
And looking at the Cavs matchup, even though they should get the win, I would expect it to be a bit of a battle. Just because they are favored doesn't mean it's an automatic W. And at this point, there simply is no doubt that Kevin Durant is one of the great shooters to ever play the game. The only question is just where on the all-time list will he land when we talk about the unstoppable score. Big miscommunication on defense. defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Boy, the defense looks shell-shocked. I mean, they're on the ropes right now, on their heels.
Now, here's Canton. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. And with Durant, perhaps the most amazing part, he can have quiet nights, Greg. And here's Nash. He's got six. Shoots over Dinwiddie. Count that one, and the Nets' lead has been cut down to 9 in the bucket from Nash.
He might be in tight, but Jay Steele has plenty of work to do here. Nice interior finish.
Harris outside. Dinwiddie outside. Good, and Harris gets the assist. Dinwiddie's got his second bucket of the night. Celtics trail by 11. Jay inside. Dinwiddie covering. And too much time in the lane. They get called for the 3-second violation. And this break gives us a moment to look at the leading playmakers among rookies for the past 10 games. Shea, number one.
And the assist numbers the past few weeks have shown how well he's fitting in chemistry-wise for this team.
Well, I think fitting in is an understatement. I mean, he's flat out taking charge, running things. That offense looks exceptional when it runs through him.
Boston's gotten one of 6 three-pointers to drop since coming out of the locker room at halftime. Wanamaker the pass to Chain. They kick it out to Green. Fires from deep. Here's Kanter. Another shot. That one doesn't drop. And Brooklyn will come the other way. Out of bounds, Celtics ball as Boston keeps possession. And the Celtics making a change here. Murray's checked in. 1:52 left here in the third quarter. Good on the three-point shot. And 11 points for Jay.
Jay with laser focus on that jump shot. Hand right in his face, and he still knocked it down.
Harris passes to Dinwiddie. And he banks in the layup. Dinwiddie's got 4 this quarter.
And the defense, no factor, which is why he simply laid it in.
Feeds to Kanter. Excellent.
Oh, purée.
That's leading by 10.
Applique-toi.
To the inside. Harris banked in off the glass. Harris has got 7 points.
You know, Harris loves to shoot it outside, but I like seeing him capitalize from there, too.
Nash against Dinwiddie. And Kanter now, top the key. Murray outside. 6 on the shot clock. Fires the 3. Allen with the rebound. Allen's got rebound number 8 now on the night. Down low, here's Dinwiddie. Again, the Nets for 2.
The plan of attack is obvious. Get the ball inside.
Ah, je suis plus dedans. Et quand je suis plus dedans, je fais n'importe quoi, mais fois 1000.
Here's Murray. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. It goes on Taurean Prince. That one is off. LeVert checked in for the Nets. Tatum, he's checked in for the Celtics. Good on the second free throw. 24 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. Now, here's LeVert. He's guarded close. Five on the clock. Launches a 3. The shot, no good. And so it's Brooklyn. 13 points up at the end of the period. They've been putting on a clinic in the paint. Now, let's listen into the huddle of Brad Stevens.
Games like this, you find out.
And 1 quarter to go in a game that, to this point, has not been an evenly fought contest. On the court right now for the Celtics,
Tatum and Kanter together down low. Then there's Jaylen Brown. Then it's Che. And it's Wanamaker in at the shooting guard position. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. Mark, a big part of your game was rebounding. You controlled the glass so well. What's one thing you would tell young viewers if they wanted to improve the rebound?
You know, I'm a little bit out of the norm here, but the biggest thing to me for rebounding is pursuing the ball. Boxing out is important, but pursuing the ball and good timing are the most important elements of rebounding. And that's what I would have players focus on. Pursue the ball.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
And really a reflection of their superior effort level to this point. It seems to me they've gone after this win a little bit more.
And Kanter over to help. And Harris wide open. He shoots offline with his three.
And on an open look like that, he's very gifted at making the weak coverage pay.
Kanter, and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. And taking a quick look here, guys, at the hustle stats for the Nets.
The activity level defensively, I've really been impressed with. There's been an attack mode on the defensive end.
Yeah, I think you also have to give them a lot of credit for how well they've risen up to meet shooters, to challenge shots in this game. A lot of blocked shots tonight.
Marcus Smart checked in for Brad Wanamaker. A few possessions into the fourth quarter, just over a minute played. Harris kicks to Dinwiddie. Good, and Harris gets the assist. Dinwiddie's got 9 points now in just the second half.
Encouraging signs for him after starting the game poorly. He's picked it up here in the second half.
And the foul on Joe Harris. That is his first foul of the game. Dinwiddie against Nash, and two free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the content. It goes on Spencer Dinwiddie.
There's an aggressiveness to Che's game that I think everybody can appreciate and respect. Prides himself on keeping pressure on the defense.
Both shots good from the stripe. Fourth quarter now, we're about a minute and a half in. Dinwiddie with it. Back to Prince. Just 5 on the clock. And he tries off the glass, but it's no good. And it's Smart with the ball for the Celtics. It's a 14-point game. At the conclusion of this game, they're off to Washington, but they'll face the Wizards in the midst of a 4-game road trip right now. That'll be game number 3. And the basket is good. And that's 15 points for Nash.
You know, with his in-between game working, Che can cause all kinds of problems. I mean, the mid-range jumper, a real important shot for him.
Pass to LeVert. Pulls it from the elbow. And Kanter pulls it down. Kanter's got 7 rebounds in the game.
And, you know, even though they're on top, they're winning. I mean, they could use more from him. They're trying to shut the door on this one.
That one goes in. And that's now 17 points for Nash.
Boy, for Che, it's been one great play after another tonight. They cannot keep him in check.
Dinwiddie against Nash. Dinwiddie kicks to Prince. A pass to LeVert. Floats one. Stolen by Smart. And here we go. Fast break with Che. Off the mark. And a chance to trim it to single digits. Brooklyn leading by 10. And the foul called on Che. That will get him his 4th foul of the game.
And that 4th foul, guys, might force him to scale back the aggression from a defensive standpoint. He does not need, nor does the team need, number 5.
Here's what Brooklyn's going with right now. DeAndre Jordan's checked in for Jared Allen. Kevin Durant comes in for Joe Harris. And Irving subbed in for Dinwiddie. That free throw good from Kyrie Irving.
We're still waiting for that first miss from the line this half.
100% since halftime? Come on now. I'm not sure this lead's going away anytime soon with that kind of marksmanship.
Yeah, good job to take it right at the game.
Yeah,
really left him no choice there, Greg. He had to foul and keep him from converting the easy bucket.
And Cantor drops them both. Brooklyn's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Here's Irving. Count it from 12. Irving's got 5 points in the quarter.
Boy, he's demanding the ball. He wants it, and he's coming through. I mean, you can see why his teammates trust him down the stretch, guys.
Jay inside. He's covered by Irving. And it's Jay missing.
It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
And it's out of bounds. The Celtics will take it the other way. Smart finds Brown. Irving against Nash. To the paint, here's Cantor. From down in the low post, it goes. Nets leading by 11. Pass to LeVert. Outside Jordan. Inside. Here's Irving. That one doesn't go. Great D that time from Jay. Up top, Brown, guarded by KD. A nice shot by Tatum.
Well, they're getting stops, and they're attacking on the offensive end.
You know, it's taken a big run, but they were able to get back into this one. Very impressive. No quitting these guys.
Irving lays it up off the glass. Irving's got 40 points.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now. Pretty early to be over the limit. That foul situation is something we want to keep an eye on.
And the first one at the line is good. Well, Clark, at the college level, a coach was recently offered a lifetime contract. Think we'll ever see that in the NBA?
Well, you can't quite say never.
Right.
I said in college basketball, I never thought in my lifetime I'd see a 16-1 seed. So never say never, but it's not going to happen.
Well, but you've got a lifetime contract doing this, so I guess it does happen in some quadrants.
Well, you got information that I don't have.
Now, LeVert. Outside Irving.
Well, one more and that's it. He'll be DQ, disqualified. He's got to be able to defend without picking up that last disqualifying foul.
Both free throws good from Kyrie Irving.
And at the line, it's all about consistency with him. His routine, his strokes, it never wavers.
It's Nash with the drive. And it's sent back by Irving.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the chart.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
Nice shot by Smart.
Yeah, Smart, a dominant player in a number of ways, but consistency with the jumper, I think, would put him over the top.
Now, here is Irving. Passes to KD. The 10-footer misses off the left iron.
Just not there from a rhythm standpoint right now. It's really eluding him.
And the shot is good. 20 points for Jay.
It's really been a tale of two halves, guys. A slow start, but this quarter, he has really been the man.
Irving against Nash. LeVert with a wide open look. And again, it's the Nets missing. Celtics trail by 7. Smart dishes to Nash. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle.
Just
two shots coming up. It's going to be on DeAndre Jordan.
On the inside now, Jay will battle you. He'll fight. He doesn't.
doesn't let contact rattle him.
And not a single free throw attempt in that first half, but he has been far more active since the break and drawn some fouls.
And it's Irving with the ball for Brooklyn. 17 points was their biggest margin. A shot off that time. Great D that time from Tatum. Here's Nash. Good work defensively by KD.
I think he'll think twice about attempting that shot next time. The defense was right on top of him there.
Prince's shot is good.
And Durant just great at picking apart the defense. When they leave one of his guys open, he is quick to get the ball to them.
Cantor. Rebounded by the Nets. Jordan's got double-digit rebounds now in the game.
A good board there, Kevin, but overall they're getting slightly out-rebounded.
And that's a good place to start if you're going to try to find your way back into this game. Get to work on the glass. Way to work the glass, buffet style. Second chance bucket. They can make a big difference.
Here's Nash. Rebound, Brooklyn.
Putain, il veut pas rentrer.
Prince has got six rebounds here tonight. Brooklyn leading by nine. Three-pointer, LeVert. Hands with the ball out of bounds. Jordan touched it back.
Not sure what he was thinking about with that pass. Just sailed it right out of bounds.
Dinwiddie's checked in for Kyrie Irving. The Celtics have gone through the fourth quarter shooting 50%, 7 of 14. In the corner, Tatum with it. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Tatum's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Inside, outside, mid-range doesn't make any difference. Tatum comfortable anywhere because this guy is a bucket getter.
Now a timeout call by Brooklyn.
And starting to send guys to the line.
Non, ça va pas du tout. Ça va pas du tout, du tout, du tout, du tout. Defense
going here. That should be the emphasis and get away from the sloppy fouls.
Now the presentation of our Jordan player of the game, Kyrie Irving.
And guys, no doubt who our pick was going to be. He's made everyone else on the court look like they're playing at half speed. It's been total domination, and you can't help but just sit back and admire that performance.
What a connection he has to these fans. They love him here. And the more he has games like this, the deeper that connection gets.
Les mecs, ils ont les rebonds chez nous.
David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Thanks, Kevin. Kenny Atkinson had some words for his team during the break. His point to them was...
Oh, putain, tu mets pas ça! Putain, le mec, je lui donne des caviar et tout, non mais... Servi sur un plateau, quoi.
Nash against Dinwiddie. Jay passes to Cantor.
Oh mais... Toi, je te donne plus la balle, toi, c'est fini.
And of course, this is Smart's biggest hurdle. Sometimes he looks great shooting the three. Sometimes, though, it's just the opposite.
Now a timeout call by Brooklyn.
And Kevin, he saw his guys just a little sluggish out there. Oftentimes, a timeout.
Putain, puis là, ils mettent tous, ils mettent tous les, comment on appelle ça, des temps morts tout le temps là. Comment ça casse le rythme.
KD. 5 to shoot. LaTrey and Dinwiddie with the basket on the assist by Jordan. Jordan's got 3 assists tonight.
Well, I like seeing Dinwiddie get going from deep, guys. I mean, this is now a reliable shot in his arsenal.
Nash kicks to Brown. Nash takes the three. Rebound, Brooklyn. 17 points was their biggest margin. And the foul called on Shea. Eight seconds left in the fourth quarter. And here's Walker outside. Hits the three-point bomb.
You know, that's why Walker's the guy that really stirs the drink for them.
Mais qu'est-ce que tu t'excites?
And so it's Brooklyn with the win.
On perd. C'est joli, il a mis un 3 points, mais ça sert à rien. Ah bah comme par hasard, pas d'interview. Bon, désolé. On va s'arrêter là pour aujourd'hui. Je suis désolé du dernier, enfin de l'avant-dernier match qui a bugué parce que je sais pas comment ça se fait, et du dernier match parce que. Je sais, au bout d'un moment, j'étais pas dedans et puis voilà, quand je suis pas dedans, voilà. Et en plus, j'arrêtais pas de faire conneries sur conneries sur conneries, donc voilà. Je vous remercie quand même d'avoir regardé cet épisode. Je vous dis à très bientôt pour la suite de notre route vers les playoffs. Prenez soin de vous. À ciao.